All right. Well, hello and welcome. Welcome in. Hello. Today is Thursday, which means that it is vlog day. And yeah, you know what? I got a vlog for you guys. We happen to have a very special guest in the office this week. You may know her from her YouTube, the Culture of Clouds podcast, RubyCrewShop.com, Lane Cove, Vapor Supply, Inc.
Just Vapor.
Star Wars episode podcast. Other things. It's RubyRoo. I have RubyRoo here with me in the vape lair. She's going to be sitting here the whole time.
Yeah.
The whole time. And we're going to go through
vape, hang.
Yeah. Hang.
I feel like we're recording the podcast.
We're not. We're not recording the podcast.
Okay, it's the vlog.
It's the video cast.
Video cast.
Video cast.
Yeah. What's up?
Really?
What's up, Thursday vlog? This is dope as hell. I haven't been on the Thursday vlog since it was like a Sunday vlog or something like 2 years ago with Matt and V.
Vlog day has always been Thursday.
Has it?
Yes.
I was trying to get that thing out of here.
Turn it on. We're going to be talking about that later too. But yeah, so this was a thing that it kind of just,
happened.
It doesn't matter. The backstory doesn't matter.
No, they don't care about that.
RubyRoo and her husband Josh are vacationing in San Diego, California. Mm-hmm. It happened to fall on August 8th.
Yeah, and so, we arrived here on August 8th.
Yeah, they flew here on August 8th. And so, you know, this was planned way before August 8th was a thing.
Yeah.
And so we kind of are using this opportunity to put together some advocacy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to talk about advocacy very heavily in the vlog. We're going to talk about advocacy very heavily in the Culture of Cloud podcast this Sunday.
Oh, yeah.
And we're going to be going over, you know, a bunch of the August 8th stuff. What does that mean for us as YouTubers? What does it mean for vape shops? What does it mean for liquid owners? What does it mean for vapers that are consumers? But we're just going to go. I have a very normal outline for the vlog this week. And RubyRoo is just going to be here to inject her.
Chill and inject or interject.
Inject.
You want me to inject?
Yeah, you know, when people say inject your special brand of hilarity or comedy or commentary.
Yeah.
Commentary. In this vlog. So I'm trying to keep this vlog very edit free, but we're going to start off.
My vlog wasn't turned on.
I got my vlog notes. your mod wasn't even turned on. You're not even, do you even YouTube, bro?
Mm-mm.
Nah, apparently not. But I got my vlog notes out here, and the first thing, what does it say at the very top of my vlog notes?
Fat cow.
So it says fat cow in quotes. Evidently, last week in the vlog, which you may or may not have watched, there was a fella who had passed away, and I was requested to blow a fat cloud for him.
Mm-hmm.
I guess in the vlog, I don't remember saying this, and even rewatching it, I don't think I said it, but everybody in the comments was like, ha ha ha, you said blow fat cow. So I don't know. Maybe people are hearing things that they want to hear.
Maybe.
But
maybe you did say fat cow.
Or maybe I did say blow a fat cow, of which I apologize. I did not mean to say that. I did mean to be respectful and blow a fat cloud for this gentleman that had passed away. And so I apologize for saying blow a fat cow in last week's vlog. After that,
super
I got no pitchforks.
No pitchforks.
No pitchforks. So last week I had talked about a vendor who was basically not supportive of any sort of advocacy.
Yeah.
This vendor wasn't taking part, donating money, doing anything it, right?
Yeah.
And so I have decided that I'm not going to crucify anybody and there are not going to be any pitchforks. I'm not going to call this vendor out.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a lot of people who really were into it. They were like, I want to know who this is so I don't spend my money with them. If you're concerned, if the vendor that you are giving money to is not supporting advocacy, all you have to do is ask them.
Yeah, ask them.
Ask the few vendors that you shop from. Because everybody has like 3 or 4 or 5 vendors that they will shop from. If you're worried about it, ask them.
Yeah.
And they, you know, they will tell you what they have done for advocacy or what they have not done
for
advocacy.
Or they'll just lie to you and be like, oh, I've given $10,000 to not blowing smoke.
Well,
I can verify that.
Yeah, we have, there's ways to verify, exactly, there are ways to verify it. And so if you're worried about whether or not the vendor you shop with is supporting advocacy or doing anything, you know, relating to advocacy or HR 2058 or the Cole Bishop Amendment or the lawsuit or all this stuff, all you have to do is ask them. There was a lot of people who publicly and privately said, there's no need to call this vendor out. It just, a witch hunt just causes further division. Mm-hmm. It's something that doesn't need to be done. And I totally agree. So I'm not calling him out. I apologize if that upsets you. But if you're really worried about it, you can contact your vendors that you buy from directly and ask them how they're supporting advocacy. And if they are said vendor, then they'll tell you nothing. I'm doing nothing. We're doing nothing. And then you go, oh, okay, well, thanks for... I'm not
thanks for taking, nothing.
Yeah, well, thanks jackhole. For nothing then.
What's jackhole? Not sure where that
jackhole is the thing.
Jackhole.
You know what my new favorite thing to say to people is, mm-hmm. is because of Rick and Morty is a dip ass. Yeah, you know way to go, like, dip ass.
You know when you're having like a really bad day? Yeah. My new favorite thing is to say, this is shit stained.
Well, or, that's good.
Shit stained or shit soaked.
Shit stained.
Like, I'm having
a shit-stained day.
Shit-soaked day. Shit-soaked. How's your day going?
Oh, shit-soaked. That conjures up so many awful visuals.
Yeah, like a piece of fabric.
Shit-soaked.
It's just like... Ugh. Sorry, guys. Sorry about that.
Yeah, shit-soaked. last week or in a previous week, this is something I would normally edit out.
Burp life,
dude. I have like indigestion or something. It might have been the nachos.
Really? Those would give you indigestion?
I don't know.
They weren't spicy.
I don't know. They were a little spicy. Anyway.
Do you think those were spicy?
A few weeks ago, I had talked about Jennifer Berger Coleman, who is hand-delivering letters to politicians.
So cool.
And she had asked me previously to give out her email address so that people could email their testimonials, their stories of how they stopped smoking traditional tobacco cigarettes and started vaping as an alternative. I forgot we can't make any health claims. I almost said something else.
Yeah, you can't say that.
As an alternative. So I emailed her and I said, is it too late? Can people still send their testimonials? And she said, it's absolutely not too late. And her mm-hmm. quote, her exact quote that she gave me was, I'm not going to stop until we win.
That's awesome.
And I was like, that's badass, Jen. You are badass. And so in the description to this video, I'm going to be posting a link to her email address. So if you have... you know, your story of vaping and you want it in the hands of politicians, you can email it to Miss Jen Coleman and she will hand deliver it to politicians for you. So that's really cool. I'm going to post that in a link to in the description as well. Mm-hmm. So we do have some other advocacy stuff to talk about. Like I said, this is just a normal vlog. We're going to have beer, we're going to have shout-outs, we're going to have first impressions, we're going to have a retro vaping
that I brought,
supplied by the RubyRoo.
Yeah, and, it's so great.
We're going to wrap it up with my favorite comments of the week, and hopefully I'll have to do very little editing on this.
Yeah, let's hope for the best.
But we do have a lot of first impressions. This is just heads up. It's probably going to be a pretty long vlog because there's a lot of first impressions.
Yeah,
going
and
on
when
here.
We sit in a room together, it's just like
we start talking and we forget that there's a camera on or anything, and we're just like anyway, The Office.
Let's just talk about The Office and Star Wars.
Hopefully everything is in focus right now, and hopefully we're not blue, because right now we look blue.
We look so blue.
But we're not going to be blue. I promise to fix that.
Blue man group. Just got to go get blued up.
I guess you could say I blew myself. that's from Arrested Development.
Yeah,
so, I'm going to let you read. What does this say? New Zealand?
New Zealand legalized nicotine-Sydney. You asked me to read
it. Where did it go? Where did that article go?
I don't know.
Oh, here it is. New Zealand. So this is something that a person named Sydney sent to me. And this is recent. This is as of August 2016. New Zealand is kind of taking a UK-ish stance towards vaping, where New Zealand was very, very strict before. Kind of like Australia.
Yeah, Australia is like no nicotine.
Yeah, Australia is... quit or die. Mm-hmm. No nicotine, no harm reduction, stuff like that.
When I was in Australia, like, there were so many smokers.
I'm just gonna tell.
I mean, probably not as many as maybe like in Europe, but like in the city, there was just like in Sydney, there was just smokers everywhere.
Yeah,
like smoking, and throwing butts on the street and everything. So
throwing their butts on the street.
Throwing their butts on the street.
Unbelievable, Australians.
But smoking is still a huge issue in Australia, and they don't let people vape nicotine there.
Really?
Yeah. Basically, if you're a vapor in Australia, you're a DIYer. Because you have to add in your own nicotine.
That's no good.
No.
That's no good. Oh. But anyway, so New Zealand is taking a very UK-ish stance. They are wholeheartedly sort of embracing vaping. Mm-hmm. The idea of, nicotine without smoke. The idea of tobacco harm reduction. It's pretty fantastic article.
Awesome,
I'm going to link to it in the description. There was quote in here that I read. I'm going to do one of these jobbers, and it says
he just made the screen really big.
Yeah, okay, super big. Here, let's see. This is pointless.
I'm gonna just narrate exactly.
The Prime
what
Minister,
touching his mouse.
Dr. Murray Logson, who's been working on e-cigarettes since 2017. His quote says, "I am absolutely delighted." Mm-hmm. He said, "This will be a turning point that will have a significant impact on reducing death and disease caused by smoking. It also gives us a real shot at achieving a smoke-free 2025. So, boom, New Zealand, done. Let's all move to New Zealand and just vape our faces off.
New Zealand is awesome, too.
Yeah.
Let's move there.
In Lord of the Rings.
Dude, let's go to Mordor.
Let's go to Mordor. So I'm going to be posting a link in the description to that article where you can read all about New Zealand. And if you're in New Zealand, celebrate. Rejoice.
Yeah.
Celebrate victories.
That's dope.
I did have this article as well.
That's a weird picture.
Yeah. It's an article about the FDA shooting itself in the foot.
Yeah.
It goes on and on about the Royal College of Physicians. There was some interesting stuff here that I didn't know this was a thing. This is Wells Fargo. Is this the bank? Wells Fargo Securities? Is that a thing?
I think so.
So Bonnie Herzog, the senior tobacco analyst at Wells Fargo Securities.
I feel like I should look this up or
something. I don't know if this is... Wells Fargo is the bank, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Wells Fargo Securities is the bank? Is that the bank?
Know. You're going to have to
Why
ask.
Would a bank have a tobacco analyst? What does that say? Wells Fargo Securities Banking Services.
Yeah.
So it is Wells Fargo.
Mm-hmm.
So this is from Bonnie Herzog, the senior tobacco analyst at Wells Fargo Securities.
Mm-hmm.
This is what she had to say about the impending FDA deeming regulations.
Mm-hmm.
She said, And keep in mind,
they're actually not impending anymore.
Yeah, they are.
They are now.
They are now.
They are now.
They are here.
Yep.
Welcome to post August 8th.
Welcome to regulation.
Welcome
bitches.
To regulation city. And so I'm assuming that by having the title of senior tobacco analyst, it's something that she's been doing for a very long time. She's probably looked at a lot of data, mm-hmm. probably did studies
stuff,
and
things.
Like Phil Bisardo graphs and stuff like
graphs.
That. There has to be like
a
pie chart, a graph, a line graph, a
mm-hmm.
bar graph.
A pie. Do you already say pie?
I said pie. I said pie
They're
chart.
They're the most
yeah.
delicious of graphs.
Pie charts. This is what she had to say. And they highlighted this website. What is it? CliveBates.com. He highlighted some things that I'm just going to read it. She said, Bonnie Herzog, senior tobacco analyst, Wells Fargo Securities, said, we expect to see a continued shift in consumption of e-cigs / vapor back to combustible cigarettes
mm-hmm.
as e-cig choices become more limited, a net win for big tobacco. This has continued to baffle us given the FDA's public health priorities. Yes.
Mm.
I mean,
yeah.
That's something,
yeah,
obviously, yes, that we already knew. It's interesting to see someone who's outside of the industry
yeah.
also coming to the same conclusion.
Yeah, being like, this is an obvious government oversight and big tobacco wins.
Yeah, big. This is a win for big tobacco. Mm-hmm. One of the other things she says in this article is, our main concern remains that the final deeming e-cig regs will realistically stifle innovation, which could dramatically slow industry growth by de-incentivizing. What? That is a crazy word that I've never used.
De-incentivizing. That's good.
Could dramatically slow industry growth by de-incentivizing customer conversion from combustible cigs to e-cigs. Mm-hmm. This ultimately has a net negative impact on public health, which is clearly in direct opposition of the FDA's goal.
Mm-hmm.
Boom. Boom. Roasted.
Boom, roasted.
FDA just got roasted by Bonnie Herzog, the senior tobacco analyst at Wells Fargo Securities, which I didn't even know was a thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that there's a link to this in the description to this video. I'm going to put it under the advocacy?
Yeah, dude.
I mean,
put it under advocacy. It's okay, awesome.
There you go. So there's an article there in the advocacy section. What I want to do now is, that's kind of wraps up the top of the show. What right. I want to do quickly is do a quick what I've been vaping with mm-hmm. RubyRoo included. We're just going to breeze through this mm-hmm. because we do have some post August 8th stuff to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
Are you mocking me?
Never.
Do I do that a lot?
Yeah.
Well.
Let's get some statistics wrong, too.
What statistics?
This tank has the 5 mil capacity.
Yeah. Well, you
the
know.
The Arctic doesn't come apart.
It doesn't. Mine still doesn't. You want me to get it out and prove it?
I'll
mine
prove never it came right apart. Now.
I'll prove it right now. I'm so mad I can't even vape right now.
Oh, you should vape.
But we're going to do a quick what I've been vaping. Really quick what I've been vaping. We're going to talk about post-August 8th stuff.
Sorry.
We're going to drop things all over the desk, even though I specifically asked you not to. That's the opposite of what I just asked you to do.
Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. Mi casa, mi office is C office.
What?
Sue office.
I don't speak.
My office is your office.
Sick.
I'm
going to throw stuff everywhere.
I'm going to steal this roll of twisted messes.
I'm going straight for those stab wounds.
40 gauge Canthal. It's basically just hair. It's so thin.
It's so cool.
What was I talking about? Quick what I've been vaping. We do have some August 8th stuff to talk about. We're going to do beer, shout outs, first impressions, and other things. Mm-hmm. So... yes, before we get to first impressions, we get to what I've been vaping...
I have a thing I want to say.
I think, Ruby, you have a thing
I just
you
have a quick
say.
Thing I want to say.
Quick thing.
So, since, like, the scramble of August 8th, mm-hmm. We've been having to push out products. Myself, yourself, other mm-hmm. people in the industry.
Mm-hmm.
We're mainly known as being, you know, like, YouTubers
mm-hmm.
and social media people.
Mm-hmm.
And we make videos and reviews for the community.
Mm-hmm.
So... of course, I am a business owner in the industry, so I need mm-hmm. to get products out. And I just don't understand how people think that I could be, like, pushing products. Like, you know, I feel like I'm a really genuine person, mm-hmm. you know? I would never, like, oversell. Mm-hmm. I would never oversell anything. Like, here, like, would never oversell. I just don't like the idea of people accusing me of over-branding. Pushing products, mm-hmm. it just doesn't make any sense, you mm-hmm. know? I just, mm-hmm. I do so much, and I don't want people to think that I'm a complete sellout at all. Like, I just, you know, don't want people to think that I am in this for the money.
Right.
So, yeah, I just wanted to, you know, throw that out there.
Yeah.
I just, you know, absolutely. I love the community.
Yeah, I love the community, too.
I would never try to, like, pull the wool over anyone's eyes.
Never. Everyone. I would never accuse you of that. Yes. I would never accuse anybody of that, honestly.
Yeah, because wool's so scratchy.
Well, who likes wool?
I like wool sometimes.
Nobody likes wool.
Nobody likes
it's
wool.
It's like wearing burlap.
Burlap sack.
Burlap sack. Anyway, we're going to do a really quick what I've been vaping. Let's start with RubyRoo.
Sick. I only have two things because I'm traveling.
Yeah.
And I had a bunch of stuff.
You didn't
bring
everything in your office?
Yeah, just throw it all in like its own separate
ship
suitcase.
It here on a pallet, like in a wood crate.
Yeah. So I'm traveling, and right before we left, I had like two other setups I was going to bring. And then I was like, I don't want to bring this.
Okay.
So I brought like one mod and the Juul. So I'm vaping on the Juul.
Juul.
Give me that Juul. And the only reason I say it like that is because V from Suck My Mod says it like that and it cracks me up.
Yeah.
So yeah, vaping on the Juul. Cool, man. Freaking love this little dude.
Yeah. I've actually vaped it yesterday.
You want to vape it?
It didn't make me cough like a crazy person.
You have to take like exactly like a cigarette style drag on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a rectangular e-cig.
That's nice.
Dude, right? I didn't think I was going to be a Juul person at all. At all in the slightest. But yeah, apparently I am. Cool mint.
Yeah, I'm going to buy another one. Casey stole my Juul.
She lost it.
Yeah, she lost it. It'll turn up eventually. It's somewhere.
I have lost this twice, but it was it's in my purse. So I like had to dig for it, and I thought I lost it. Oh, I can't find the Juul.
Yeah.
Dig? Anyway. And then I've also got a DNA 200 dot box.
Dot box.
With a recoil RDA on top.
Recoil RDA.
I've had this set up for like 2 weeks now.
Yeah.
And I just love it.
What's the juice in it?
Oh, this is Blue Slushy from the new RubyRoo line.
Slushy. How do you spell it? Oh, it's Slushy.
Slushy.
Blue Slushy. That's how I would say it.
Oh, well,
in French,
be
it's actually.
It
Le Bleu Slushy.
Le Bleu Slushy.
I'm trying to brush up on... I'm trying to learn some French because I'm going to Paris for an event and I don't want to get in my Uber and be like, jus d'orange?
Je m'appelle jus d'orange.
He's like, your name is orange juice?
Your name is orange juice, clearly.
Like, oh, you speak
American.
English? He's like, no.
No.
Ah, shit.
Shit.
Yeah, shit.
Ow. Oh, God.
Ruby's injured. Her rib meat is injured.
I... strained a rib muscle, and so every time like I cough or laugh, it really, really hurts. That doesn't matter. You guys don't care about that.
Don't care
anyway.
About that. I'm going to blaze through mine real fast. This is all going to seem...
I was talking about Blue Slushy.
Yeah, we'll get there when we get
GaslightVapor.com.
I have Axis Vapes M17, my original green guy. Recoil RDA on top. That is with Grim Cult. Vape Capital.
Double toot.
I think I talked about this in the podcast, but...
ooh, that's delicious.
Caramel Corpse doesn't get much notoriety in the Grim Cult line.
Mm-hmm.
And just as a heads up for most of this vlog, we both have a bunch of new juices that just came out. So that's why we're vaping what we're vaping. There's going to be other juices included. I have a buttermilk pie that I'm going to taste. There's a V-God juice I'm going to taste. There's a bunch of other juces, but goes back to like, don't think that we're just trying to be self-serving. It's just that we did just both release juices, so that's what we happen to be vaping today. It's no big deal. Recoil RDA, Axis Vapes M17, Caramel Corpse is great. I kind of forgot how good it was. I really like it.
Can I vape it? I want to vape what you've been vaping on lately.
Yeah, Cannibal Corpse or Caramel Corpse. Sorry, don't say that.
Don't say Caramel Corpse?
No, don't say Cannibal Corpse.
Oh, yeah, no.
We don't want that.
Infringement.
Hexome V3, 25mm Sub-Zero RDA. I am vaping the Watermelon Lemonade from the RubyRoo line. I have noticed... you want me to give you some feedback on this juice?
Only if it's awesome.
Okay. When I texted you, I said this is going to be your biggest seller.
Mm-hmm.
And I do believe that's going to be your biggest seller.
Mm-hmm.
I have this weird thing where sometimes...
watermelon.
At night... no.
Oh, sorry.
Sometimes watermelon tastes like celery. This one doesn't have any celery in it. But sometimes at night, I just can't vape certain juices. They make me cough.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know why that is. It's only been happening for like the last 6 months or so.
Hmm.
But there's some juices like Dynamite Fuse. Like,
well, that's so throaty.
It is pretty throaty. Even like that Sticks, the strawberry wafer Sticks.
Mm-hmm.
I can't vape that at night.
Mm-hmm.
Watermelon Lemonade is a vape I can't vape at night.
Mm.
I was vaping it...
Well, vape it during the day.
I was vaping it all day when we were shopping at IKEA.
Mm-hmm.
I came back home. I took one big pull on it. I was like...
Do you even vape, bro? It just hit me. Yeah, like
it
all
hits
wrong.
Me. Good throaty juices hit me low.
Yeah, low throat.
And throaty juices that make me cough hit me high.
Up here.
Yeah, high.
Mm-hmm.
This is a high throaty juice...
yeah, dude.
And I don't know, it just hits me weird, but it's delicious. I think it's going to be your biggest seller.
I like it a lot.
Try it in this.
Okay. I'm just going to try all of yours.
It's good. Try all of them.
This is fun. This is what you, like, watching the vlog, you always want to do. You always want to be able to
try
it.
You always
want to
try what I've been vaping.
I will try it for you guys.
And she'll report back, like, honestly.
Yeah. Caramel Corpse tastes like it has chocolate in it.
It does. It's chocolate caramel. Oh. There's that palette. It's chocolate caramel. This is the Finder 75 from Vapor.
Holy crap.
Something.
It is good.
Yeah. Think Vape Finder 75. A lot of people had questions about this last week. It's just a DNA 75 double 18650. I've really been enjoying it. Watofo Serpent Mini 25mm on top. This is Rainbow Sherbet in the Dark. It's good. The flavor on this Serpent Mini is actually really nice if you want to give that a shot. And lastly, no real surprises here. This is the Noisy Cricket. Yes. Wismec Jabo is releasing the Noisy Cricket 2. As soon as it's available, I'm just going to buy one because I want to buy one. They're also releasing a new RDA to go on the Noisy Cricket 2 that has a neutral center post, which is awesome. Mm-hmm. I really want to try that.
Yeah.
As it stands, I'm using the other Jabo atomizer, the Cillian, C-Y-L-I-N, the Cillian. It's a bit weird. I still haven't figured out how to use it as a tank, but I've been using it as a dripper, and it's really great. This is YIG, which I haven't vaped in quite a while, but I associate YIG was the first juice that I ever tried on the Noisy Cricket, and so I associate the Noisy Cricket with the YIG juice.
Oh, sick.
And
that's a good trick.
This
that
is
looks
only,
like a hot vape. Is that a hot vape?
It's not. Try it. Okay. It's freshly wicked, or it's freshly wet, and it's only a single coil. Team single coil.
Seam tingle coil.
Seam tingle coil.
Man, I haven't vaped on a Cricket in like 1,000 years.
Try it. Hit it. And there's no way it's been that long either. Try it.
I'm really old.
We're going to watch Ruby cough maybe. It's not hot.
I think it... Did it? It's misfiring.
It's because you're holding it wrong.
No, I'm not.
Hit it right there.
I don't thumb...
I've been having misfires with it.
I don't thumb fire Crickets. I do opposite. I do this way.
That's weird. Don't...
I'll just do it on the edge.
Okay, do it on the edge. I've been having Noisy Cricket-ish button issues again.
What juice is that?
YIG.
Why does YIG taste so different? I don't remember that much. That's the cookie one, right?
Yeah, that's the blackcurrant oatmeal cookie.
I don't remember it being that cookie-ish before. That doesn't eat. That tastes like oatmeal.
Yeah, like it's oatmeal cookie.
It's good.
Yeah.
I just completely forgot how that
if
juice
you want
tasted.
A bottle, I'll give you a bottle on your way home.
Okay.
Okay.
Sack.
So yeah, that's what we have been vaping. Sweet. That was only 10 minutes.
Dude, we're
just
so plowed fast.
Through that like pros.
It helps that I only have like 1.25.
Yeah, and I limited mine to. I mean, obviously, I have other stuff. I've been vaping the Nautilus Mini, which I'm not gonna put a link to in the description. 18 milligram juice. You want some throat hit, yo?
Frick yeah, I do.
Mm. I feel like P. Bisardo every time I vape that.
Really?
I don't know why.
It or just Kevin think. Skipper.
I feel like Kevin Skipper.
Mm-hmm. That's fantastic.
So good.
That poorhouse flavor is good.
Even the Mad Mix?
Even through the 18 milligram,
yeah.
It still has a really nice flavor.
The poorhouse Mad Mix is dope. It's a good juice. Super good juice. Throaty. It's so throaty.
Oh, that reminds me of when I first started vaping so much.
That's what bums me out is after like 3 or 4 toots, the throat hit goes away.
Oh, and you're like just like chain vaping 18.
And I'm like chain vaping 18.
And then you're like.
So I have to do that like set it down for a little bit and then come back to it.
I have to do that with the Juul actually.
There's some other stuff that's going on there. So let's jump into life after August 8th.
Mm-hmm.
How about that?
Mm-hmm.
How about we do that? I have a website here. This is fdaregs.info.
Mm-hmm.
And it's here. And this isn't the timeline. So they have a timeline. I wanted to talk first. There's a lot of questions. People have questions
out
questions. There. I would highly encourage you to go to fdregs.info. They have a whole fuck ton of information there.
Yeah.
They talk about what is and is not a tobacco product. They include, you know, they talk about they specify liquids are definitely a tobacco product.
Mm-hmm.
PG and VG are tobacco products.
So nonsensical.
But they said, and some people are confused about this, it says it includes any component that is not made, excludes mm-hmm. any component that is not made or derived from tobacco.
Mm-hmm.
So this is where a lot of people are getting the, hardware will be okay, mm-hmm. type of thing. But yeah.
But hardware is intended to be used with a tobacco product, e-liquid.
Right.
So that makes it a tobacco
product. That makes it a tobacco product. So what they include is a finished tobacco product. They specify finished, mm-hmm. meaning everything that's in a finished that you can vape with.
Yeah, like a
battery, a tube,
setup, and juice.
Yeah, a screw. If it's used to vaporize liquid, it is a tobacco product. It's dumb, I think, and confusing that they excluded that mm-hmm. in the initial covered tobacco product, but they also have finished tobacco products that include all of the parts
yeah.
that are sold separately or as part of a kit or that's sold separately. These are all tobacco products. Mm-hmm. They also include this last part, which is confusing to me.
Mm-hmm.
Small scale tobacco product manufacturer. A manufacturer of any regulated tobacco product with 150 employees or fewer and total revenue, an annual total revenue of $5 million or less. So that basically covers
a lot of the industry.
That's the entire industry.
I mean, there are some e-liquid companies that make very good money because they have a ton of different lines.
Right.
And like co-packing facilities. But I don't know if any single manufacturer has over 150 employees.
No, I worked at a Starbucks roasting plant and we didn't have 150 employees there.
I think we had 150 employees like at the very time I worked at New Belgium.
The whole
And that's like a mid-sized beer.
Yeah, that's a big beer company. Well, I mean, not big beer, but yeah. it's a large beer company.
Yeah.
The whole total revenue of $5 million or less,
mm-hmm.
that's like 90% of the industry.
95%.
Yeah. There is like, I can't even think of a vendor
that
makes over $5 million a year.
I can.
Who? Do you want to say names? Are we naming names?
Well, they're the big tobacco companies who make vapor products.
Right. Right. Yes. Altria. Sure. Philip Morris. Sure. Definitely more than $5 million.
Because the government has now lumped us in with those guys.
Right. But hobby vapor companies, even non-hobby vapor companies, even, do you think Juul?
Oh, like PAX Labs?
PAX is over 150 people, $5 million?
I don't know.
I don't think so.
I don't think they have that many employees. That's an awful lot of employees.
I can't imagine.
Yeah.
So I just thought that was interesting. Let me make sure I get to the right link because the camera's covering it. Timeline! That's where we wanted to get.
You guys got a sick shot of Nick's neck.
So, after August 8th. Yep. This is August 8th.
This again is at fdaregs.info.
fdaregs.info. They have a whole timeline.
Click on the regs, like little clicky bit.
Clicky bit on the regs.
Click on the regs.
There's a drop-down menu.
Go to timeline.
So this is, we're basically just kind of going to go over a lot of this stuff, mm-hmm. what it means for us, what it means for everybody, really.
Yeah.
So no new products or changes to existing products can be introduced to the market until the FDA authorizes such through a marketing order based on successfully completing either a SE standard equivalency or PMTA pre-market tobacco application pathway.
Which I still don't think it's going to be possible for small companies to pass a PMTA in the slightest.
No.
Or have money to pay for it.
No.
Yeah.
And there's no, and the thing is, and here's one thing that is really dumb. I can't even think of a better word, which is really dumb. The PMTAs are big, long
processes,
huge
processes.
Applications yeah. where you're filling in loads and loads of information. And the FDA has said that if there are discrepancies or mistakes,
yeah, they chuck it out.
Even so much as a spelling error.
What?
Even so much as a spelling error that you are automatically denied.
That's so messed up.
Automatically denied your PMTA.
Ugh.
So even if you can afford, I don't know, $1 million for...
Yeah, a million and up.
To get some of your products through a PMTA, mm-hmm. if you fuck up the application,
it's an
automatic fail.
And then you have no more company.
And then you're in debt.
Yeah, you're in debt.
You're also in debt $1 million to the federal government. So no new products after August 8th can enter, or changes to existing products.
Right.
And there's some questionable...
Yeah, like, can I change a bottle but not change the label?
Right. And can you change the logo.
Yeah. Can
you do that? Can you change the logo on the bottle?
Also, we're not lawyers.
Oh, yeah. If you have a question about this, try to contact Azeem from Right to Be Smoke Free. Maybe he'll know, but a lot of this is written so poorly that there's no real super clarification
on
any of it.
And if you're a vape shop owner, or you own an e-liquid company, or you make vapor products, and you have questions about this, you need to join up with like SVADA or VTA or somebody.
Yeah,
like
somebody.
A trade organization that has lawyers on retainer that they can answer these questions for you. Mm-hmm. So... Ooh.
Yeah, there's some weird gray areas. Can't sell to anyone 18. Okay, why did they phrase it like this? You can only sell to customers 18 and older.
Mm-hmm.
Need to check photo ID of everyone under age 27.
Yeah.
That's widely accepted by the vapor industry. That's something that we've been self-regulating for years now. So there's no surprises there.
Unless you live in the state of California.
Online.
Or like Utah has kind some of weird news.
Yeah, Utah's 21 and over. Utah has no online sales.
Yeah, I thought Utah was like 19 or something.
Oh, yeah, Utah is 19. Yeah. California's 21.
Yeah.
New York's 21.
Yeah.
Utah's 19.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere else is 21 as well.
Yeah, I can't remember.
I can't remember.
If you're from that state.
Yeah. Hey, let us know in the comments below. But yeah, this is different for brick and mortar stores. It's easier to see the photo of ID of someone who comes into your brick and mortar store.
Yeah,
and
you like,
okay. And then you shine it the little light, make sure it's real.
Yeah, use the UV light.
Done. Online, totally different story. There's some expensive age verification things that you can do. A lot of people are going the route of... if you make an order, before they can even process it, they have to call you on the phone.
And like talk to you.
And talk to you and verify that you are of legal vapey age, I guess.
And they'll change that with your shipping too. They'll require a signature when the mailman comes to your door.
Someone over 21 has to sign for it. So there you go. I mean, that's a thing that's going to happen. This is an interesting one as well. No free samples. You are not allowed to give away free samples.
Do you know what that means?
That means no more giveaways.
No more giveaways.
That means I can't ever do another free giveaway.
Yeah.
Can't.
That sucks.
Just can't.
I just did a huge one on my Instagram.
Yeah.
And it was awesome.
People got so much cool
stuff.
Yeah.
And I got, I had like 7 large flat rate boxes all left my house and into the hands of really awesome vapors.
Yeah, which is amazing.
And I can't do that anymore.
Yeah, no more free samples.
Let's just open up an eBay.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
No more
we're
free
not,
samples.
We're not doing that.
That includes going into a shop and wanting a drop of e-liquid.
Yep.
No longer. You will have to pay for that drop of e-liquid. I was told that the sample price has to be for profit.
Yeah, it can't go. You can't like have your jar in your shop and be like, "Here, put in a quarter."
Put in a quarter,
and we're gonna donate that money to Not Blowing Smoke or to the
it
the
has to
coalition
be
or
for profit.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to figure
you
out a workaround that we could
people.
Do like a raffle for giveaway.
Raffle would be cool. That's what we
but
kind
that
ha- of
but
did
it has
with
to be for profit.
I don't want to make. I don't. Ugh.
I don't want to.
I know.
Want
to do this.
I don't I want money to... in my. I don't want subscribers' money in my responsibility.
No.
Just to win stuff.
No.
So what? You know.
It feels that feels so icky.
Okay. Yeah.
So I mean, we're gonna have to figure out.
We're
how
trying
to
figure
do
out a
giveaways.
Workaround to still do giveaways because giveaways, according
are
to
awesome.
This, according to the FDA, yeah, they're awesome. People but, love winning giveaways, and
yes.
I love doing giveaways, and I love giving away
stuff. So
and
awesome.
According to the new FDA regulations, after August 8th. Giveaways.
That
can't do any giveaways.
I just
can't do any giveaways, which is a huge bummer.
We're gonna have to figure out how to get free stuff into people's hands somehow.
Yeah, we have to. I mean, we have to.
We have to.
Yeah. What if it? Oh, it has to be a substantial amount.
Hmm.
What if you have people mail you quarters?
What if you have people mail you
because
warm
then
change?
That's
you
an,
want people's
that's a
change?
Substantial enough amount, but it's not enough to add up. I mean, I have on average maybe
pennies.
400 or 500 people enter a giveaway.
Mm-hmm.
How much is 500 quarters, Math A?
500 quarters?
Yes.
Is, Math A.
Figure it out.
That's a joke from the podcast.
Yeah, what is it? What is it? I don't know what it is. But it's not like...
They'll tell us in the comments.
I just don't... Ultimately, I don't want to, like, make money for doing a giveaway.
I know.
That's so dumb.
Yeah,
that is so dumb.
I don't want to do that.
So second to last thing post August 8th is you must prevent product adulteration by operating your facility in a sanitary manner to avoid contamination of manufactured or shopped?
Yeah, shopped products?
Shopped
Maybe
products.
Maybe they mean shipped products.
That could pose a risk to public health beyond the risk of the product itself.
What the hell does that mean?
It basically means it means you have to have a lab environment where anything more dangerous than nicotine isn't going to get into the liquid.
Oh, right. Like, so you don't accidentally, like, spill bleach into your liquid.
Right, yeah.
Like, what?
So this is, I mean, this is so common sense. It's kind of like saying, well, if you want a driver's license, you can't drive into oncoming traffic. You know that, right? Like, you go,
yeah
I wasn't going to do that anyway.
I wasn't going to come close to doing that.
I know Lane Cove's made in a lab.
Mm-hmm.
I know all of my lines are made in a lab, an ISO lab, and so... Yeah, this is we've been doing this for years now.
Yeah, years.
Years. This is actually a pretty reasonable regulation, and I think it's weird to be included in the August 8th. And this could be a thing that maybe isn't necessarily directed at vaping.
Yeah, that sounds like maybe like, I don't know, do you think they have a ton of bottles of bleach at like the tobacco?
Well, it could be like a cigar thing. Like, what if there's a practice in cigars where you're including like paper towels and tobacco rolled into a cigar.
That sounds gross.
Or something. You know what I mean? Like, there
Check
could
out
be,
my bag on
there
paper
could
towel
be
cigars.
Tobacco drying areas where it's like, oh, well, this is hanging over manure or something. Like, it could be more for cigars and tobacco because
could
they're
be.
Included in this
they
August
are.
8th thing
yeah.
as well. So the last thing for August 8th is you must avoid any and all misbranding of products, as the FDA will start enforcing false or misleading labeling and advertising.
Oh.
This includes modified risk claims.
Yeah.
So you can't
put on your label or any of your marketing
that talks about,
and us as business owners can't say it.
I can't say it. It's you can't make any modified risk claims.
Nope.
You're not allowed to say.
You can't say it.
I can't say it. You can't say anything.
Go to our Instagram August 7th. Go to our Instagram.
Yeah, that was the last
That's
time.
That's what we want to say.
We were legally allowed to say it. The FDA will start enforcement.
Yeah.
Enforcement. And look, I'm not...
I can't believe that the government is limiting our right to free speech.
Yeah.
That's
because we're
so
business owners.
Because
we're business owners.
And it's been scientifically proven... The thing we can't say, but we can't say it because the government, don't get me started on this.
Government and Vinyl and Vapor on Instagram, shout out to Vinyl and Vapor on Instagram. He had a great post about
how
he is a customer. He's not the business owner. If you have any questions about vaping, ask him.
Yeah, he's like a customer at a vape shop, and he was sitting outside of a
with
vape
a
shop
sign.
With a sign.
That says,
can't do it, but I can help you. Yeah.
And I was on another podcast recently that we're going to talk about this in the shout-outs called Rising from the Ashes. Great guys, great podcast. And he had a very similar idea.
Mm-hmm.
He said, if you run a vape shop, you get your regulars who are there
like,
anyway.
Yeah, they're there hanging
they're
out
there
anyway.
They're hanging out anyway. Yeah. You give them a t-shirt that says not an employee.
Oh, right.
And have them help the customers set up their shit, because if you work in a brick and mortar store, you can't help the customer even put in a battery.
What?
You can't
You definitely
help them
can't
put in a battery.
Build a coil
you can't build
for
a
them.
Coil. Mm-hmm. You can't show them how to put a coil head into a sub-ohm tank.
Oh my God.
You can't do it for them. You can explain it. And they can see. Here's where it's dumb.
So you can like note like hands behind your back, like
no,
and then like
you can do it. So if they bought this sub-ohm tank, which I don't remember the name of it, it's from Coil Art.
Right.
So if they bought it and you have one, you go okay, go like this.
So you have to have samples of all the products behind the counter
that
everybody
can. They
can
mimic you.
Yeah.
But that's as far as it goes. You can't build them coils.
And you can't actually, and like, you can't, do it for
they
them.
They can't mime you building coils, if that makes any sense either. It's a lot of effed up stuff in the a-hole. You can't... There's so much happening right now.
Welcome to life
after regulations.
After regulation, guys.
It's ridiculous.
And that is why we have to continue this fight.
Yeah, that's why for the last... what popped up in my Facebook, memories was the first video I did a year ago about supporting HR 2058. Yep. That's why for the last year...
Year.
We have been talking about these regulations.
HR 2058. Year.
That's why for the last year we've been talking about supporting HR 2058. That's why for the last year we've been trying to get everybody to join CASAA. That's why for the last year we've been getting people to follow Not Blowing Smoke to get companies to join a trade organization. Because for the last year this has been coming slowly.
And now
it's passed and we have to deal with it.
Yeah, we have to deal with the blowback.
And this isn't even close to the end of the rollout of regulations. There's more stuff happening in December as well.
And I have a feeling they're just going to keep revealing more things, or like amending things and
as they go along.
They're like, oh, we'll figure it out.
Yeah, it's the same thing that happened with the caps, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, the whole cap thing.
Where they said that vape shop owners would have 180 days to sell off old stock. And then at the very last minute, Friday before,
they said no.
They're like, you're going to have no days to sell off your stock.
No days. So there were vape shops with no juice.
Yeah, because they couldn't sell it because the FDA told them they'd have 180 days. And then the Friday before this rule went into effect, the FDA said, oh, I'm sorry, no, you have no days now. So take all that liquid down from your shelves. You can't sell any
of it.
And
even if the e-liquid did have certified caps, they had to have the actual
certificate
in hand to prove that the products that they had were in compliance. So such a mess.
It's such a mess, but
we're going to get through it, dude.
Yeah, I absolutely believe we're going to get through it. There's positive things happening, like with what happened in New Zealand, what's happening in the UK.
Yeah.
There are more and more critics constantly of the FDA regulations.
From outside
the industry. Other politicians. There was what's-his-face, the guy that was at Pittsburgh Faircloth.
Yeah.
There's Ron Johnson. There are six other senators that joined Ron Johnson as well against the FDA. So people
and
are
like,
now...
very well-known people.
Yeah,
like,
very well-known
Senator
people.
Rubio is a part of that team.
Yes.
He's like... hounding the FDA. Yeah. Like, why are you doing this?
People are being very critical of the FDA, so we need to keep that going. We need to help change public perception. Yeah. If you have a testimonial or anything, you can send it to CASAA. You can send it to Jennifer Coleman.
Yeah.
We need to get our stories out there.
Write letters, you guys. Get on the phone.
The public, unbelievable to me how they have swayed public opinion to think that smoking is better.
I know.
And I shouldn't even be saying that, but how did that happen?
I don't know.
We need a better public image. I'm not the guy to do it because tattoos and metal.
Yeah.
Ruby's tough with her half sleeve. It's good.
It's getting there.
Yeah, tough. We can do it. Do that pose.
Oh,
we
like
can do it.
The Rosie the Riveter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah. Stay vigilant, stay the course, persevere. I do believe that we can fight this.
Absolutely.
And I want
to. We have to.
Yeah, I mean, I want to be part of something that's bigger than myself, and I want to be on the right side of history.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
We're going to change the world, guys.
It's going to be
so
dope.
Good reg stuff. Good reg stuff. What we need to do now to make this vlog even longer is go over there to the beer section.
Oh, are we recording?
Yeah, we're recording.
Oh, shit.
So we're going to taste some beer now. I went and got this.
I know this is out of focus. I'm aware of that.
It's out of focus. Nobody cares. Why did you...
I wanted just show them.
Look at this mod. I know it's out of focus, but can you see it at all?
You can kind of see the bottle.
What we have to drink today is Modern Times Fruitlands. This is a beer that I bought at BevMo the other day.
Mm-hmm. It's Fruitlands, Passion Fruit, and Guava.
Passion Fruit and Guava.
It describes it as a sour tropical fruit. Huzza.
A what?
How would you say that?
Oh, stop it.
This is my favorite thing.
Ghost.
That's a dang I'm ghosty.
That's a ghosty.
I'm pretty sure that this Jose? Is a huzza.
Huzza?
Which is also, Americans pronounce it goose.
Huzza.
And it's like it's a Belgian.
It's a beer or is it like a saison?
No. Well, both of those are beer. Beer and saison is beer. Huzza is also beer. Anyway, we're going to drink it. It's going to be awesome. I get the honors.
RubyRoo refuses to let me look at Beer Advocate, which is fine.
Beer Advocate.
We're going to just pour it into the Modern Times tulip glass.
Which I really wanted to use, but he wouldn't let me.
Nope. I'm using it because it's a Modern Times beer. It's in Modern Times cup. Modern, bit of a Modern Times fanboy.
I'm using a GrimmGreen tulip glass.
Well, it's a Grim Army tulip glass, but that's very close. I know.
I'm gonna put my finger in your beer.
I know.
I'm gonna start dropping mods in it.
The owner, I know the owner of Modern Times. Did I tell you this? Mm-hmm. I'm name dropping right now.
We're doing a vigorous pour.
The Beer Jesus. He calls himself the Beer Jesus.
Oh, that's
unfortunate. He actually, I don't know if this is public knowledge, so I won't say anything.
Okay.
He started Modern Times Beer after working at a different brewery. He left the other brewery, which is a very popular, good San Diego brewery, still on very good terms with them.
Oh, good.
He left to start Modern Times. I first fell in love with Modern Times because of the Black House coffee stout that we tried.
Yeah, so good.
I saw the white can. I love their branding. Yeah. I'm like, I want to try this beer.
It's so retro.
Casey like really pumped it up like, this is such a good coffee stout.
No, you said that to me.
Yeah,
you were like, this is such a good coffee stout. And I'm like, well,
we'll see how
it goes. And then I was like... so good.
She made that exact sounds too.
I'm pretty sure I did.
It was kind of like a sea lion.
Yeah.
Ugh. Do you want me to taste it first and try to describe it to you?
Let's do it together.
What can I expect from this beer?
Well, we have some notes on the back
there are
here.
Some notes. Okay, but, well, let's read this first.
Let's drink it first.
Here's to the future of vaping.
Here's the future of vaping.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
It's
that is tart and
amazing. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of sour tartness.
Ooh.
It's not like I was expecting it to be a little vinegary.
It's a session sour.
This is
kind of like
sour.
A new beer style that's very popular right now.
Okay.
Sours for so long have been like very, very sour. Tons of like vinegar, acidic.
It's
in there.
Sour, but it's not.
But it's a session sour, so it's less sour.
Yeah.
More effervescent.
Very effervescent.
It's good.
Jump cut.
Yeah, this is dope. Let's look at the flavor notes.
Yeah. What does it say?
So, it's only 17 IBU. IBUs are your international bittering units or bitterness units.
Bitterness levels. Mm.
So 17 okay, is not bitter at all. Passion fruit, guava. So they're calling it. It's using Pilsner malt and malted wheat. So it has a wheat in it. That's cool.
Mm.
Pilsner malt, malted wheat,
or
light.
Quit.
Fruitlands is tart, fruity, and frighteningly delicious.
Frighteningly
the even. Sour, salty base beer lays down the funky refreshment while a heavy dose of passion fruit and guava turns the whole thing into a wall-to-wall tropical fruit fiesta. It's a marvelous mix of elements that collides with your mouth like a fruit-filled asteroid of flavor traveling at the supersonic speed of party.
Yeah.
That's the coolest beer description I've ever read in my life.
Well, yeah, wait till we go to the Modern Times Brewery. We're going to go to the Modern Times Brewery tomorrow.
I'm going to buy so much stuff.
Yeah, and they have a wall of 1980s compact discs.
Oh.
It's like the whole wall. And then they have other ones that are like comic books.
I'm going to buy so much stuff.
And it's like a working brewery, so they have a bar area in
the
front.
Can we take a tour?
I don't know if they have a tour. I might be able to get on the horn with Beer Jesus and ask him.
Like, bro.
I've been meaning to...
You could name drop me.
Oh, he'll know about RubyRoo from New Belgium?
No, but he'll know that I... It's okay. We'll talk about that later.
Hmm.
It's okay.
Hmm.
Meant just say certified Cicerone. Just mention that, and they'll be like, oh, nerdy motherfuckers.
Those nerdy Cicerones. But it's a working brewery, so they have a bar area and a sitting area in the front, and then right behind the bar, it's like roped off, and there's like forklifts.
Oh, shit.
Like grabbing down pallets of hops. And
I like your forklift impression.
Well, this is...
No, it's good. Boop, 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 boop. It's good.
You have to bend, lean it back so you drive. Yeah. Anyway, so we're going to go to Modern Times.
Forklift.
I would like to try this again, like on tap.
I want
to
drink all of this beer. It's really good. I want to drink this beer until it doesn't exist anymore.
The more I drink it, the more I like it. The first sip of it is very pungent.
Yeah.
It's very pungently sour. And then as you drink it more, a lot more subtleties come out. Like you get a lot more like the sweetness of the passion fruit and the guava. And the sour level kind of goes down.
And this is like a series. So they have like an apricot. They have a cherry. I really want to try a session cherry.
So good.
My favorite beer of all time is the Transatlantic Creek from New Belgium.
Mm-hmm.
Favorite beer of all time.
You just say that because you worked there. You're so biased.
I know. I just love shoving products down people's throats. It's my favorite thing to do.
Totally is. But Transatlantic.
Transatlantic Creek.
Transatlantic Creek. From New Belgium.
That's a sour cherry ale, and this this has a very similar, like,
I had
goodness.
The other...
It has a similar goodness.
This one, I've had the City of the Dead. It's a grape one, I believe.
Ooh, grape.
It's a grape, what's it called? Melcon.
Oh, Achuse.
Achuse.
Yeah, it's or a gosi.
A gosi. It was a grape gosi.
Well, goose is spelled differently. Goose is spelled differently in French, so I might be totally wrong.
I'm going to pair Rainbow Sherbet in the dark. Rainbow Sherbet in the dark?
That's going to pair perfectly.
This? Bro,
I'm going to do slushy.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Blue slushy? That's not going to be good. Yeah, that's a good pairing.
That's really
good.
Did
you hear my Finder 75 keep firing after I let go of the button?
No.
I had to like tap it.
I just thought you were taking a really long drag. I'm like, damn, Grim.
Let's try that again.
Okay.
Yeah. Rainbow Sherbet in the dark's great.
Can I show you my favorite goofy vape trick?
Goofy vape trick? Like Goofy the Disney character?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's going to be great. You usually have a cocktail. Just, it looks like this. There's a straw in it. Usually don't do beer. Pretend this is a cocktail. Ready?
I think I know what she's going to do. Oh! That's like a mad laboratory. Mad laboratory? Mad scientist laboratory.
Yeah, dude. And then, it's so fun.
And then you tornado out of it.
It's so fun to do with a cocktail. I do it almost every time I have a cocktail.
Yeah.
I turn it into
a child.
That
makes your gosi nice and foamy.
Yeah, look, I just re-foamed
Nothing
it.
Nothing better than a foamy gosi. A foamy gogh.
Oh, gogh. I could be wrong about that.
But yeah, this is great. I wish I could fly RubyRoo here every week to do the beer pairing with me.
I know.
Me.
This is...
Because you add so much to it, I wouldn't have said half of the things that you said.
Dropping knowledge.
I would have been like, this is a sour goose. It's really sour. I don't know anything about it. Modern Times. That would have been the whole thing.
Because you don't have beer advocate to rely on.
That's true. I do. It's my crutch.
It is your crutch.
RubyRoo, you're so elitist and you make fun of me.
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah.
That's
good. That's good beer. Good beer. Good beer times. Good beer times. What I'm going to do now, even though RubyRoo never watches this segment of the vlog, it is time to get to some shout outs.
It is shout out time.
All right. Well, we got to some. See, usually I mess up, and then I'll just edit it later.
You suck at
But now
this.
I mess up, and I have someone to laugh at me, which is great. All right, well, we got some time to do a couple shout-outs here. I know that this is RubyRoo's personal favorite part of the vlog.
I love shout-outs.
She loves the shout-outs. Every week, she watches the vlog, and she texts me, and she's like, knocked it out of the park with that shout out segment.
Mm-hmm.
It was so good.
So good.
Really, the shout outs are really one of my favorite parts of the vlog anyway. Even if you skip them, that's fine. They're still one of my favorite parts. If you skip these, shout outs are not for you then. Don't ever request a shout out.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know
mm-hmm.
who watches the shout outs and who doesn't.
Oh,
and
yeah.
That's who I'm giving shout outs to, is people that watch the shout outs. So I'm never shouting out RubyRoo.
Never again.
Never again. Nope. Nope. I don't use the Ruby Crew juice line. I don't love the watermelon lemonade. I don't like it anymore.
I'm just kidding.
So I'm going to look at this.
Hat switch.
You see this?
Time.
I'm not a football guy, but this is a Pittsburgh Steelers hat.
Football cream.
So I was at VCCPA 2015. Were you at 2015?
Uh-huh.
Okay, I was going to say, I don't think you were there.
No, Matt was there.
Yeah, Matt was there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's right. 2015. And a guy named James gave me this hat in 2015, over a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, hey, you know, I'm really glad you came to Pittsburgh. It's really great to meet you. I want to give you a gift. I want to give you a Pittsburgh Steelers hat so you always remember Pittsburgh. And I was like, that's amazing. Like, if someone gives me a gift, that's something that I value more than 1,000 new mods. You know what I mean? It just means a lot to me.
I love presents. I love handmade presents, too.
Yeah. Or presents
someone
that
have
meaning.
Someone brought me, like, a birthday card and a beer once.
Yeah.
I was like, we're best friends now.
Yeah.
Get in here. Let's
gifts
hug it
that
out.
Have meaning. And so he gave me this hat, and I said, absolutely, thank you for this hat. I want to give you a shout out. Will you sign the inside of the hat so I remember who you are? His signature is in the side of this hat. And can you even read what that says?
It just looks like big oval, little ovals, big oval.
Yeah. So I had no idea what this guy's name was for a year. And I've held onto this hat hoping he would email me and say, hey, I haven't seen the Steelers hat in the fucking vlog. What the hell's your problem? And I could go, oh, good. I know who you are now.
Mm-hmm.
It's a fellow named James. And he came up to me in VCCPA 2016.
This year.
And asked me about the Steelers hat. He's like, hey, I'm the guy that gave you the Steelers hat. And I was like, I kept it.
Yeah,
I kept it waiting for you. I was waiting for you. So James wrote to me and said, it was great seeing you in Pittsburgh again this year. As we discussed.
Mm-hmm.
I'm writing this email to have you wear that awesome Steelers hat I gave you in one of your vlogs. My name is James. I enjoy watching your videos as it does help determine what products we carefully consider having in our shop. We are located in Indiana, PA, Platinum Vapor and Lounge. Mm-hmm. We do carry your Epiclouds line. That's awesome. Thank you. And it's a big hit. Our best seller is the Cardamator Crush, followed by the Caramelized Banana. Thank you for taking the time to see me this past weekend. James, absolutely, you were shouted out. Thank you for the Steelers hat. If you're in Pennsylvania, PA area, go visit Platinum Vapor Lounge. And
mm-hmm.
evidently, they're Steelers fans, which I believe everybody in Pittsburgh.
Well, not
Pittsburgh,
yeah.
is a Steelers fan.
And a Penguins fan. And a Pirates fan.
There you go. I'm going to wear this hat the whole shout-out time in honor of James over there at Platinum Vapor
mm-hmm.
and Lounge. James, thank you so much. I do have one shout-out that happened via Facebook, and I'm not going to be able to read this because the text is so small, but Justice. It's a he. His name is Justice.
Mm-hmm.
He writes to me and says, hey, Nick, my name is Justice. I'm a big fan of yours. I try my best to watch your videos and give you support for all your... all you are doing for our vaping rights, but I am blabbering about fan things. I don't know if this is too straightforward to ask, but I was hoping you can do a shout out to my older brother. Older brother Thunder?
Sick!
Is your older brother's really named Thunder?
I hope so.
Dude, that is
badass.
Dope. That is badass.
Yeah. Is he a superhero?
And anyway, Thunder. His brother's name is Thunder, apparently, and his fiance, Brianna. And wonderful newborn daughter, Arrow Lynn. Yes, you can use our names. Wait, Justice, Thunder, and Arrow?
Uh-huh.
Are you sure you're not forming a superhero team of some sort? He's the one who helped me get into vaping and introduced me to the vape community. I've been vaping for about a year now, and I was hoping to give him a big shout out to my older brother and his new family for staying strong and showing me the route of a smoke-free life. Please, please... shout him out for me and show him that I truly appreciate him for showing me the right path of vaping, smoke-free life. Absolutely. Team Justice.
Heck yeah.
Thunder and Arrow. You are all shouted out. Those are the greatest names of all time. I hope you have t-shirts. I hope you have
superheroes. They need a logo. You should make them a logo.
I should make them a logo. Yeah. I hope that you acquire superpowers someday.
Yeah. Because if you don't already and you're just like, you don't want to like give away too much. Yeah, you don't want to be
behind, you know, low key. And then so that's cool. Yeah, so absolutely. You're all shouted out. I do also, I'm not going to read this whole thing, but I do want to give a quick shout out to a fella on YouTube. Left a comment on one of my videos. He goes by Yankee Cantrell. Very, very helpful. He gave me some information on lipo packs. He said he has years of experience with lipo packs. He used them in a lot of his hobbies. I was worried about my lipo pack expanding in my whiteout DNA 200. And he said, no, that's actually kind of a normal thing. Depending on how big it gets, they can get, you know, it happens to like 30% of all these lipos. So it's not really dangerous unless it gets past a certain size. Anyway, he was just really, really helpful. Mm-hmm. So I definitely want to give him a shout out. I love helpful people that are helpful in a helpful way.
Wow.
And aren't helpful.
I love people who are redundant in a redundant way.
No, but you know what I mean? There's people who are like, if I'm like, for some reason, this is leaking. And even if he's right, but he says it like a dick, like, oh, well, obviously you need to replace the O-ring on the bottom, duh, dummy.
Yeah.
That's being helpful as a dick.
Yeah, that's just.
I like people that are helpful.
Yeah.
In a constructively helpful. So
constructive.
Yeah. So Yankee Cantrell. Thank you. Thank you so much for that info. We're going to do a birthday shout out. Sick. And this is really long. Oh, but wow. Essentially, Thomas, it is his birthday.
Burp life.
Today.
Thomas, that was for you.
Which is August 11th, Thursday vlog day. Mm-hmm. Thomas, it is your birthday. So I'm going to give you a shout out. He is a huge fan of the vlog. He said he's a huge fan of the Culture of Clouds podcast.
Yeah,
so RubyRoo, there you go. He was a smoker for 21 years. He finally switched over to vaping. In big bold letters, he wrote, "I'm never going back." And yeah, absolutely. Good. I think that's very cool, brother. So definitely get a shout out. Happy birthday. I hope it's full of just lots of vapor. Lots of vapor. Possibly gifts or cake.
Mm-hmm. Oh, cake!
I would
is
love
awesome.
Some cake right now.
I want to eat.
I would love
cake
some cake right now.
Right now.
Yeah, that cake really would be good. So great right now. Got another couple shout outs to here to do. Dempsey. Dempsey wrote and said, "My boyfriend loves you." And how can I not open an email that says, "My boyfriend loves you"? But she wrote and said, "Hey, Nick, my name is Dempsey. My boyfriend Sage used to smoke those cancer sticks until he heard about e-cigarettes. He started out with the blue e-cig until our small town of Bismarck, North Dakota." Is Bismarck the capital of North Dakota?
Oh.
Come on, geography land.
I'm not good at capitals.
You're the one who's
though.
Like, okay, wait, okay. Wait. What's below Tennessee? And I don't know, and she makes fun of me.
No, I said, what are the states surrounding Colorado? And he knew, like, you were like, Utah? Is that one of them?
Anyway, their first small town of Bismarck, North Dakota got a vape shop. Little by little, he wasn't smoking cigarettes anymore. Yay! He started watching your videos on YouTube a few months ago, and now he doesn't miss a single one. He tried to get me into vaping, but as I have never smoked a cigarette before, I didn't have much interest in it. But I'm so proud of how far he has come in just a few years. He would love for you to give him a shout out. Absolutely. Dempsey, you are shouted out. Sage, you are shouted out. As my vlog viewers know, one of my favorite things of all time is couples where one of them vapes and one of them doesn't, but the other one is still supportive of the vapor.
They're not like, oh,
that's my favorite. That I love like that. Expensive. I don't think anything shows true support is when you support, you know, your significant other's passion or hobby, even though you have no interest in it.
Yeah.
I think that's just a fantastic thing. So thank you. Thank you so much, Dempsey. You are definitely shouted out. Yeah, we got another birthday shout out here. So Cynthia.
It's late.
I know it's late. I can't always nail birthday shout outs.
I know. Okay.
It's just a thing.
Yeah.
Cynthia writes to me and says, "Hey Nick, I was wondering if you could please do a birthday shout out on your vlog to my wonderful boyfriend, Anthony. His birthday is July 31st. I apologize. Here's a late birthday. Fist bump. Bump both of them. Ruby, put your fist back up there.
I did.
You have double fist bumps now.
I've been giving...
Double fist bump.
Oh, with pinkies up. I've been double fist bumping everybody.
I know.
Okay.
Well, I know. He always watches your vlog every Friday when he gets home from work and his beer and vape. I thought it would be a nice little surprise for him. I'm sure you're super busy, but I hope you can do one in one of your vlogs. Thank you, Cynthia. Absolutely. Cynthia, you know what? I'm going to shout you out too. Your wonderful boyfriend, Anthony. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for supporting the vlog. I love the vlog, so I love everybody that loves the vlog. We're already instantly just super best friends. So yeah, there you go. I think, you know what? That's, we're going to wrap this up for shout outs because we do have a lot of first impressions to get to. So that's what we're going to do now. It's first impression time. Wave your hands. Makes it get here faster. All right, we got a whole mess. I would say mess.
It's a lot.
Whole mess of first impressions. Mm-hmm. What I'm going to start off with is this little guy right here. You see this?
Little tiny guy.
This is a new thing from eLeaf called the Eye Care.
Such a stupid name.
A dumb name. But it does come in a rainbow of colors, gold, black, cyan, which is Tiffany blue.
Yeah, I like
white and red. The black has a black drip tip and the rest have white drip tips. Mm-hmm. It is a USB drive. It's not.
it just looks
like a USB drive that you vape.
Yeah.
It's a mouth to lung. It's not. It's. This isn't sitting flat now. It's not a closed system.
No,
it's not like a pod system.
You can refill it.
You can refill it. This just arrived. Honestly, if you want one of these, I don't know if eLeaf sent you any.
I don't know. I have like a mountain of vape mail sitting in my kitchen right
now. There's a good chance you could have an eye care.
I hope so.
Sitting at your home.
Yeah.
But it comes with a coil head, a tiny little coil head. It's like the tiniest little coil head. And you can fill up your reservoir tank. Mm-hmm. It comes with a little tool in the drip tip to unscrew everything and adjust the airflow. And you just, you literally just mouth to lung it. This is some
can you talk?
6 milligram Mission to Mars from, I haven't vaped this.
I haven't.
This bottle of Mission to Mars is probably 2 years old.
I haven't vaped Mission to Mars in over 2 years. And it was 6 milligram. It has like the most tiniest, like crackliest little.
Yeah, you can hear it crackling like a tank.
Like a crackle machine.
You can hear it crackling like a crackle machine, like a cartomizer used to crackle.
Yeah, it sounds like a cartomizer.
It sounds exactly like a cartomizer. Yeah. Vape it. I'm going to drink beer.
Mm-hmm. Sounds like a cartomizer. I can't talk either.
It's all good. It's all good.
Sick content,
because there's so
bro.
Many distractions happening.
Yeah.
But it does crackle like a cartomizer. The flavor's really nice. It's just mouth to lungy.
Mission to Mars brings me back to Vape Bash 2014.
Yeah. What I want to do is get some higher nicotine juice in this.
Yeah, you need to throw 12 at that. 18.
What I'm really interested in, it seems nice and durable.
Yeah.
What I'm really interested in is the longevity of the coil heads, because they're really, really small.
And if it leaks.
Additionally, the one problem I ran into when I had started filling it is I couldn't prime the coil head because it's so tiny.
What?
I put like a drop on it and the drop just sat there.
And like, I was like, go down. Go in the thing.
So I'm like, all right, well, maybe I can't prime the coil head. So I just filled up the tank. I put it down in there and I was like, well, now I just have to wait for it to wick because it's
like old.
Because if you draw on it to try to get juice in there, it's going to fire.
Oh, yeah, because it's an automatic.
Because it's an automatic switch.
Yeah.
So could be some weird things in there. You might go through like two coil heads.
Trying to figure this out. Another way to actually prime coil heads like that, and I don't know, I haven't looked at the coil head, but you might be able to like completely submerge it. Like in e-liquid, like put it in a little cap and then submerge it. I don't know if that would work or not.
That might help. It might get too floody. There was a person whose name I can't remember. I actually think it's in my vlog notes. I think I was supposed to give you a shout out. Not stopping until we win. No pitchforks. Yes, there was a shout out. Oh, I didn't give a shout out to the Rising from the Ashes podcast. Son of a bitch. Go to the Rising from the Ashes podcast. Great podcast. I was on it. I'm going to go on it again. Really nice dude. And they were very super professional. They do a live podcast. And you can also see it as a podcast. Just search on iTunes for Rising from the Ashes. And super great podcast that I was on. We talked about a lot of good advocacy stuff. Anyway, Sam. Sam said the secret to the horrible Joytech coil heads is not to prime them.
Oh, don't prime
them. So, like, in that dumb EVIC AIO that you might have sitting at home.
Not the original one.
No,
the new original
EVIC
one is great.
AIO.
Yeah, I do have one.
Don't prime the coil heads, and they'll actually work a whole bunch better.
Interesting.
So that's what I was afraid of, because eLeaf Joytech, don't prime the coil heads. Mm-hmm. I tried to prime the coil heads.
And it didn't work?
It didn't work. Mm-hmm. I actually burned out the first coil head. This is the second coil head.
Mm.
Because I didn't let it sit long enough, and I took a drag, and it went, and I was like, so yeah, that's a thing. Obviously, like I always say with all my first impressions, I need to spend way more time with that before I feel comfortable doing a full review. So far, it's been really nice. It seems really durable, and the flavor and vape I'm getting from it is a solid. It's a solid little mouth to lung.
I like this little dude so much.
You might have one at home. And if you don't, I will send you one.
I'm just going to steal yours just to be sure.
Except I can't send you one because free samples. I mean, are you going to turn me in? Are you going to turn me into the
FDA? GrimmGreen sucks.
Before we get to the really fun stuff, I want to talk about this little guy right here. Now, I uploaded a video for the iPower from eLeaf.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't get along with it very well.
It broke.
Broke on me. Just straight up broke on me. Some people tried to help me. In a nice way.
Some people in a not nice
way.
Yeah.
No big deal. Just didn't work for me. So this is the iStick iPower Nano.
It's so cute.
It's tiny. It's a tiny little ovaly thing. It does maximum 40 watts. It's got a LiPo on the inside. Mm-hmm. It comes with the Milo 3 Nano as well.
Mm-hmm.
These coil heads are generally really good.
Yeah.
You've always liked the Milo
the
coil heads.
The standard Milo V3 coil heads. I have gotten along with them quite well.
This is a little white guy. It does a maximum of 40 watts, like I said. So this is a 0.25 ohm coil head. 40 watts maxed out. It's 3.1 volts.
Wow.
So that's like a really weak 18650.
Yeah, that's like a dead battery.
But honestly, I mean...
Yeah.
The vape's nice.
Yeah,
it's cool.
It's
a cooler vape. Not cool like the Bonds is cool, like a cool, but cool as in temperature. It's a cooler vape. It's not, I'm used to.
It's not that cool.
It feels pretty cool.
It feels pretty normal to me.
It feels, I vape hot vapes. I have really hot vapes.
I usually vape around 60, between 60 and 70 watts.
Yeah, that's not, I don't think I have a thing here set to 60 watts.
But this, I don't think this tank needs a ton of power.
Right, right, yeah. Right, absolutely. But it's a cooler vape. Coil head so far has lasted about, I don't know, 3 days.
Yeah.
I've put maybe 10 mils of juice through this. I literally just got it, hence the first impression.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we do first impressions. But flavor's really nice. This is dripping fruits, the sour green apple flavor.
Yummy.
It's really nice.
Mm-hmm.
It reminds me of back in the day, Pure Smoker used to have a juice called Apollonia.
Mm.
And it was my fucking, I loved this juice. Mm-hmm. I would buy it by the gallon and just vape it like crazy, 18 milligram. This really reminds me of that juice. It's tasty.
There's also another really good apple juice that I want to, not apple juice, apple e-liquid that I want to shout out. Fiona from Cooley's is amazing. It is a Fuji apple vape that is so good. You can find that at Gaslight Vapor as well. Ugh,
I'm not sure
Fiona's
of the
so
price
good.
On this guy, but I got to imagine eLeaf doesn't have prices on their website. All it is stuff.
I don't know
the price
eLeaf
of this.
eLeafUS.infoworld.net. Don't go to that website. It's not real.
Oh, they're making a Squonker Pico.
Oh.
What?
No, they're not making it. They've already made it and released it on the website.
They are released. They released. Oh, it comes in wood grain, too.
Ooh.
So black, gray, brown, white, and wood grain.
I like
Earth
that.
Tones.
I like that wood grain
I like that wood grain one.
It reminds me of a library.
I wish the tank was matchy-matchy.
Yeah, it would be cool if it was a black tank.
When
it
you
would look
buy,
a lot better.
Black tank would look better on all of these, but if you buy the white one, I feel like you should get white hardware. And if you buy the black
or
one,
like
you should get
white,
black hardware.
Or like white seals would look
cool. Yeah, white
seals.
Well,
those are clear.
They're clear, but they're white-ish.
It's racist.
Anyway,
that's racist.
iStick Power Nano.
It's racist.
I'm going to use the hell out of this little guy and, you know, obviously report back later with how it's working out. Hopefully, RubyRoo has one at home.
Hope so.
She'll be doing her review
stuff is cool.
Soon.
Yeah, soon-ish.
Probably soon-ish, mm-hmm. Which is a thing. So, the hot topic of discussion.
Mm.
Oh, this guy.
I'm so excited.
Look
to try
at this
it.
Guy. So
We
haven't even vaped this yet.
Oh.
It just came in yesterday. I just built it today, and this is the first time we're ever going to vape it. This is the Pharaoh drip tank, mm-hmm. a Rip Trippers project. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I went all project. Nah. Anyway, it's what? Being made. I said project really weird. You I was did. Like, Rip Trippers project.
Well, you got into like his persona.
I channeled him a yeah, little bit. Yeah, you did. This is being made by Digiflavor. Mm-hmm. So that is interesting to me. Mm-hmm. I have two other Digiflavor tanks. Not so good.
Well, we're going to try this one.
I know. That's why I'm trying to be optimistic. Because yeah. one of my favorite things in the world mm-hmm. is when there's a company that releases a product that I can't stand. Mm-hmm. And then that same company releases a product that I love.
Yeah. That's happened my favorite with thing. Sebum Innovations.
Yeah, Sebum Innovations yeah. is the biggest offender
they, like,
of that.
They like came out with the Big Dripper.
The Big Dripper was sucked. Garbage.
And then they came then out they released, with the Sub-Zero. Yeah,
the
which
Sub-Zero,
is amazing.
Which is one of my favorite atomizers of all time.
Yeah.
So yeah, mm-hmm. I don't know, maybe Digiflavor can redeem themselves. I will say that it took me about 2 seconds to build this.
Yeah, you like came out into the other room and you're like, that was the easiest thing I've ever done.
Yeah,
ever.
It was the easiest build I've ever done. It's got this really interesting clampy system mm-hmm. and it's different because...
It's different from the Goon.
It's different from the Goon. Mm-hmm. It's different from every other clamp system I've ever used because when you... this is something I didn't tell you. When you unscrew this, mm-hmm. the plate raises.
Oh.
It doesn't... The screw... It doesn't... It's not a thing where the screw comes up, but the plate stays down.
Oh, the plate goes up.
When you unscrew this, the plate comes up, too.
Does it have, like, springs in it or something?
I don't know.
Dude.
But
more science is required.
All I did was go, dink, dink. I put my leads in there. I have it in a single coil. Evidently, you can run this in different horizontal coils. Like, you can put a dual coil this way.
You could do dual horizontal.
You could do dual coils this way. You could do dual coils this way. I just put one fat
that's a big
framed
build.
Staple in the middle. It's super low. Oh no, it's not super low.
No, that's
it's
high.
0.4.
Throw that on the noisy cricket.
Well, when I first did it, now I don't know what's happening with this freaking limitless mod.
Don't fire it.
See why did
no
now the resistance changed?
Oh, it did. Why did it do that?
Okay, I don't know.
0.17. Do you want to put it on a different mod that we know and trust? Do
you
want to
put it on the dot box?
No, like a DNA board box. Maybe you should throw it on the M17.
Okay, I'll put it on the M17. I was going to vape it on the Limitless, but we'll throw it on the M17.
Yeah, no, that reading is weird.
It is weird, right?
We need to have as much accuracy as possible.
Yeah, that was a weird reading because it said 0.4.
And then it said 0.17,
which is weird. I want to open this airflow all the way up. It's upside down. What does it say?
X-ray vision. 0.17.
Okay, 0.17. So what do you think? 80 watts?
Well,
let's just try it. Let's just try it 80 watts. So this is called a drip tank.
Yeah. Like the theorem.
I'm going to treat it like a dripper.
Or like the limitless duder.
4 millimeter little reservoir in the bottom that you tuck your wicks
into.
It's not
really a tank because the reservoir
really
is just like a deep juice well.
Yeah, it's just mm-hmm. It's just a deep juice well that you tuck your wicks
it's
into.
It's a pool.
The airflow goes in from one side only. You see this 1, 2, 3, and then the other side just says Pharaoh. Mm-hmm. So when you drag on it, you can feel all the air coming in one side.
One
it doesn't
side.
Feel even.
It like distributes the air
and the
underneath.
Air comes. Right up through the middle.
Okay.
So I have the coil sitting right over the opening. Mm-hmm. Air flows all open on the side. I'm going to drip some of this buttermilk pie.
I'm so excited
I
for that
I can't
juice.
Wait to try this juice. I'm so excited
it
about this
It smells amazing.
It smells unbelievable.
It smells exactly like a buttermilk pie
Which
if
I've
you've
never
had one.
Yeah, never
it's kind of like a custard.
Custard.
It's kind of like a custard.
Custard.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of like a custard, but...
Do you say it like Todd?
Custard.
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 Custard. You say like custard, like custard. I can feel sweat dripping down my face.
Are you hot?
I feel like I'm diffusing a bomb right now.
I don't know. I'm getting too old for this shit.
Cut the red wire, cut the blue wire. I can't tell
Yeah, Nick is just...
I'm colorblind. I'm just loading it up with some juice.
Loading it up
I'm
with
gonna
some juice.
I'm going to fire it a little bit.
Ooh,
and then I'm
yeah.
going to put some more juice
that
on
looks
here.
Juicy.
Because when you fire the coil,
that juice.
It
That's
pulls nice. Juice into the center.
Does.
To prevent wick collapse.
Oh.
So that's why you do this.
Wow.
Okay. So.
Throwing down that knowledge.
Here we go. Now, the drip tip has the honeycomb pattern in it.
But there's one that doesn't have a honeycomb pattern.
There's one that doesn't have a honeycomb pattern that I grabbed that I'm going to put on here because
we don't like
the honeycomb patterns in the A. I hate that. I just hate it. The cap.
Especially when you bleh your juice on the top.
Especially when you bleh your juice. I don't know if you're going to be able to bleh your juice because the coil sits right over a very wide airflow slot.
It's like dripping on a K-fun.
So I'm interested to see, does this...
More science.
Okay, this is one piece. Even though there's a seam right there.
Oh, yeah.
It's one piece.
Can you unscrew that?
No, I tried.
Oh, maybe you're just weak. Maybe it's just like the Arctic that doesn't come apart.
The whole cap screws down.
Yeah.
The whole cap eventually screws down. No big deal. A little bit of juice leakage.
No big deal.
It's tall, but not excessive.
Mm-hmm.
It's tall.
Slightly taller than the Sub-Zero that we just mentioned.
Even with the airflow fully open, it's slightly restricted.
Is it?
Try the airflow without pressing the button. Just try the airflow and tell me how you think it feels.
It looks gigantic.
Yeah.
It feels pretty gigantic.
It feels restricted to me.
Nah.
I mean, not... Let me clarify.
Here.
Not restricted like a K-Fun 5. But
it's more open with than the Cloudsbro cap on the recoil.
Oh, is it?
Oh yeah, here, try.
I have a recoil. I don't need your germy recoil.
Germy, I'm finally not sick. I just have like a rib issue. A rib shoe.
Yeah, it is more open. It's more open than the Cloudsbro clouds. Okay, I just want to vape this because I want to try the juice and I really want to try this
was sick as tits.
Interesting.
Is it?
Interesting.
I can't wait to try it. I want to shut down the airflow a little. Got it set to 80
watts. Suggest re-dripping.
Okay.
Which you're going to have to... So
unscrew it?
You have to hold the base and unscrew the cap.
Okay. Because we're worried about bleeding through the tip.
I'm worried about blowing through the tip. I'm going to try it eventually.
It sounds like you're saying blowing.
Oh, see, you get juice everywhere. It's leaking. It's on the side. It's leaking down the side.
Well, let's put it in the reservoir.
I did.
Oh, you already did?
Look, you got juice everywhere over here, dude.
I'm really good at dripping. Yeah, stop moving it.
That juice just tastes... Why am I bleeding?
You're bleeding! Are you okay?
Well, I don't know what happened.
How did you start bleeding? There's like nothing sharp.
Thin skin.
There's nothing
sharp. All I did was grab the glass of Modern Times and I started bleeding.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. I don't want to cross-thread this.
Threads aren't super smooth. That's the first thing I would say. Threads aren't super smooth, but the vape quality that I just got is really nice.
Okay.
Give it a shot.
I overdripped.
Did you get juice in your mouth? You probably should have had the honeycomb thing in.
Don't make me laugh. We're trying to really evaluate this.
Go. I'm evaluating it. Did you close down any of the airflows?
No, they're still open. Oh, 80 watts is really hot.
I like hot vapes.
Don't vape
this. That's a 0.17.
Okay, can I just turn it to where I would vape this at?
Sure, you mean boring levels of wattage?
Not
sure.
From Boringand.
Boringand. Pardon me, what's in the news, Robin? I'm not editing that burp out. Sorry, Sheik. What are your thoughts?
It's way better at 62 watts.
Give me your first impressions.
No, I like this juice.
Okay, well, I'll just continue talking about something I can't vape. The vape quality that I got from those two vapes was really nice.
It's really good.
Really nice.
Wow. Yeah, okay. First impression of the Rip Tripper RDA is...
Vape quality is great.
Vape is awesome.
The vape quality is stellar. This is a framed staple, mm-hmm. 0.17 single coil, around a 3 millimeter.
Did you make it? Whose coil is that?
I made a framed staple.
I don't know.
I believe this is a Squid Dude coil.
Oh, well, Squid Dude is the boss.
Yeah. I don't know. Should we try blowing through the middle real fast? There is an O-ring on the bottom here.
Mm-hmm. To like...
So... What I think is treat it like a Kennedy. So if you...
But you paint your Kennedy coils.
I paint my Kennedy coils, but except on the three post, I don't.
Okay.
So I think you could go like...
Oh, what if it goes right down the middle?
If it goes right down the middle...
It didn't...
Juice rockets into the back of your throat. That's what happens. But you can take one quick drag and it'll pull all that juice back out.
Mm-hmm. That's a really, really good vape. Do you like it at 62 watts?
It's fine. I'm going to turn it back up to 80, though.
Okay. You don't need to turn it up that high. It's a bit of a hot vape.
Flavor's really nice. Deck's easy to build on. Airflow's really nice.
Yeah.
I don't like not being able to blow your juice.
Yeah.
I don't like having to unscrew that.
Yeah, I wish it just was like a boop, like regular.
The threads on it aren't great.
Mm-mm.
For some reason, and this is going to be very nitpicky, and I am trying not to make it sound nitpicky, I hate that the airflow is all on one side. Because you can feel where the airflow is coming from.
I don't know that you can feel it, but you can hear it.
It's all one side.
I know, but you can like hear it right here.
I like the even airflow, yeah, personally. Mm-hmm. But I mean, that is super nitpicky. But obviously, dude, like with all my first impressions.
The vape on this is phenomenal.
Yeah, the vape quality is really nice.
Good. Yeah.
Damn it, Rip Trippers.
Ugh.
You and your good products.
It's good. It's good.
Oh, wow.
What up?
Clouds, I'm surprised. Bro. I know. We need to stop vaping. And this is good.
Dude.
I'm vaping this the rest of my life. There you go. Claimed.
No, you're not.
It's been claimed.
I'm going to steal
Ruby
it.
Roo. But like with all my first impressions, I do need to spend much more time with the Rip Tripper. Rip Trippers Pharaoh there. But yeah, good time. So moving on to another tank. This is the V-God Trick Tank Pro. Did you ever try the V-God Trick Tank?
Oh, the little guy?
Yeah, the little sub-ohm tank. Mm-mm,
no.
Really good sub-ohm tank. Now they've made it pro, and it's a...
rebuildable.
Drip tank, rebuildable guy.
Mm-hmm. And you like goop-a-pa.
Yeah, so what I've been doing is goop-a-pa.
Goop-a-pa.
Goop-a-pa, or just vaping it so it points at my face.
Like Jenny style. Mm-hmm.
Now this came pre-built, so... You know Zach Free Ohms?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, Zach is making, awesome.
Yeah,
he
he's making. Yeah, he's making coils for V-God now.
Oh, sick.
And so they included some Zach coils. That came pre-built with some Zach coils.
That's really good.
So I wicked it down into just touching the base. Like,
yeah, because they're not hanging down.
No wicks hanging down. Airflow is really nice. It's Kennedy style airflow. It's in and up.
That's dope.
It is dope. And you fill it. I'm vaping their V-God juice. I couldn't find this on their website.
Yummy. That's good.
It's called Luscious.
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 That's yummy.
Yummy.
Dude, that juice is yummy.
It is yummy.
I would describe it as luscious.
It's watermelon is what it is.
It's good. It tastes like...
It's a watermelon that's not celery.
Yeah, it's not celery. It tastes like... I wouldn't say like totally natural watermelon.
No.
But it's not
kind
like
of candied.
It's not totally Jolly Rancher watermelon either.
No,
it's like somewhere in the middle. Yeah, it's nice.
Mm-hmm. Probably pairs really well with this gulg.
Is that what it is?
Gulg. I'm not doing a first impressions for this right now, but we'll do that next week. This is the V-God 150 watt box that I have it topped on. One of my favorite things is how you fill this.
Oh, yeah.
They designed it to work really well with their V-God bottles. It would work really well. Unscrew the cap and look at the tip. It would work really well with your bottles. It would work not so well with the GrimmGreen Signature bottles.
Are these the Chubby
Gorillas? No. Oh. So you pop the top off, right? And then there's a little hole.
Oh, on the side.
Right there. Mm-hmm. So you just go... Bleh.
Sick.
Comes out the top.
That's air. Look at that.
That's air coming up.
It's like a little it's like a mini little bubble volcano.
And then that's all you do to fill it. You just O-ring that back on. Mm-hmm. Little bit of spillage.
It's a tank, so
but
it's going to be a
overall,
little
overall, you're good. I was surprised that this didn't run dry on me because the wicks aren't touching the juice.
Yeah.
But when you tilt it to vape, the juice touches the wicks.
Yeah, or if you just vape it regular and you're like, oh, I feel like it might need to be a drip. And you just... Bleh.
Yeah. So far, I've really enjoyed this tank.
Yeah,
I mean,
that's
I'm not
nice.
Going to lie. So far, I've really been enjoying it.
I do like that.
It comes with an unscrew...
It comes Delrin. With an unscrew.
It comes with an unscrew Delrin thing.
Yeah, it comes with an unscrew.
And because this is a drip tank, if you're running low, you basically just drip more juice and it becomes a dripper.
Yeah, you could do that too, because the coils are juice, like right there. You can see the right coils there. You can, through the top.
Yeah, you can see the coils. You can just blit some juice in there and vape it like a dripper if your tank runs dry. It's good. It's really cool. I'm really enjoying this vape. But like with all my first impressions, I do need to spend much more time with it before I feel comfortable doing a full review. But this is brand new from V-God. In fact, this is kind of... First impressions are going to go bye-bye soon.
Yeah.
I mean, first impressions are just going to go bye-bye soon.
Yep.
I have some stuff for maybe a couple more weeks, but we'll see. You know what? We'll cross that bridge when we get there. V-God Trick Tank Pro. I'll post a link down in the description, and you can check it out if you're interested. But
also, this luscious juice is awesome if you like watermelon. That's yummy.
They have a they sent along a coconut, like pure coconut juice, too, that I've been dying to try. I'm waiting. I'm saving it for Pickle because she loves coconut.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll try that next.
But this was the first one I smelled, and I was like, I want to vape this luscious. Luscious V-God juice. Yeah. Luscious.
Luscious.
So, second to last, we're going to be talking about mods from here on out. This is the new Praxis Vapors Banshee 150 watt dual 18650 box mod. And as you can see, it's got a very unique screen. The screen is LEDs.
Yeah.
LEDs?
Sure. Yeah, probably.
Yeah. It's LEDs behind the outside of it. So
yeah, they're like,
if this turn, if I turn this off, you can see that the screen just disappears. It just goes away. It just looks like part of the, it just looks like the mod, right? But then when the screen comes to life, Praxis, SigGo, it's a little confusing at first to look at. Looking at that, what do you think is happening? So battery,
R,
resistance, 0.5 ohms. Then when you press the button, it says It says Pobow, but that's power. 80 watts.
Oh, I thought it was Pobow.
And when you adjust this, you can see
it
adjusts the watts. But when you have it at 80 watts, it looks like it says Pobow.
Pobow.
Pobow. The one quirk that I've noticed about this mod in my 2 days of using it is it has to wake up. It falls asleep, and if you pick it up after like 5 minutes of not using it, and you just go, nothing, something happened that time. Nothing's going to happen. You have to press the button to wake it up. When you see Pobow, then you can vape it.
Yep.
It's nice. The feel of it, I like this finish.
Let me touch it.
Touch it. I like that finish.
Oh, that's nice.
I like the finish.
It's
the button
not like
is
rubberized. It's
no,
but it's
no,
not
it's like,
iPad-y either.
It's like it's like soft plastic.
Soft. It feels like a soft.
What I'm really worried about, should we for science and put a try to put a mark in it?
Soft. He's taking like a thingy.
It's just this. We're going to talk about this in a second. I'm just trying to see if I can scratch it because I'm worried about it getting marred and marked. Like if this gets too scratched up,
that
the display is going to look all junky. But this is a 0.5 at 80 watts. I have Ruby Crew juice.
Sick.
Blue slushy.
Blue slushy.
In here. With the anarchist, what's that? The phenotype LS?
The short guy.
Yeah, the short guy. That's a that is a hot vape.
Great.
You want a hot vape?
I'm going to go ahead and
just try it at 80 watts.
Oh, I'm used to looking to the screen here.
No, it's on the other side.
Oh, that's weird. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's weird. The screen's on the other side.
It was actually at 79 watts.
Okay.
Ooh, it goes fast.
Yeah, it goes wicked fast.
Okay, we'll try 70 watts.
Well, you always test fire it.
I don't know.
I don't know. Hot.
Secondhand.
Hot vape.
Secondhand.
That's
I
a
turned
hot
it
vape.
Down to 70.
Okay. The only other quirky thing I've noticed about this device.
Damn, blue slushy's so good. That's yummy.
It is. What that's one thing. Okay,
I like
let's
how
talk
this,
about blue slushy a second.
No, I like how this feels.
It does. It feels really nice in your hand. Feels really nice in your hand. I'll post a link in the description. Praxis Vapors. You can read all about the Banshee. One thing that I like about your juice, the blue slushy, is that it holds up to the heat really well.
It does.
I think I told you that via text message, but this is a hot vape, and it holds up to the heat very well.
It does.
The only other quirky thing I've noticed about this device, and it is a big quirk, for some reason they have a recessed 22 millimeter 510 on here.
That sucks.
I couldn't use anything on it.
Your own RDA.
I couldn't use my Sub-Zero 24 on it. Mm-hmm. I couldn't use the Kennedy 24 on it. I couldn't use the recoil on it. Mm-hmm. I couldn't. The Pharaoh certainly won't fit on it. The majority of sub-ohm tanks that I have, the Sense one won't work on it. A dot mod will work on it. And this is 22 millimeters. This Phenotype LS will work on it. But it's a very recessed 22 millimeter 510.
That, like, look at that giant Vecino guy. That's not going to fit
No, of course not. It's not it will fit. Definitely not fit on it. This little guy will. This little tank will fit on it.
Yeah, that's
22 millimeters. Yeah. But even the Serpent Mini 25, not a chance.
You're going to have to.
It screws down till you hit the edge, and then the 510 is just like this far away from the.
And they have, like, heat sink spacers that you can get online. But it would look really dumb because your heat sink spacer would be 22 millimeters.
And then you'd have a big 24.
Big 24 what are we on need, top of it.
What you need, I don't know why they did this.
I don't know either. That's
I want it, so.
Because so many RDAs and tanks now are 24 or 25 millimeters.
The one that they sent me isn't the production model.
Are we allowed to talk about this?
Yes.
Okay.
The one they sent me is not the production model. Mm. He made sure and said that. He said, so, we're going to have production models on the site. The one I'm sending you.
There's people singing outside.
There's people chanting outside. Isn't a production model. So I'm going to email Praxis and ask them about that recessed 22 millimeter.
I hope they got rid of it.
And say, hopefully if you got rid of that, because this would look dope with a Kennedy 24. This would look really dope with that black recoil on here.
It would look good with the black recoil.
It would be sick. But as it stands, it's really comfortable. The display is neat.
Yeah.
And it's cool. I mean, I've really enjoyed...
Oh, thanks.
I really enjoyed using it. So, second to last thing. Welcome to the longest vlog in the history of America.
Sorry.
Second to last thing. This can be pretty quick. V-Park.
Oh, it's so cool. I'm so excited for this mod. It's V-Park so cool.
V-Park made a regulated tube mod. Regulated tube mod.
Yeah, like a Pro-Vary.
Yeah, like a Pro-Vary or like a lava tube.
Mm-hmm.
But they made it dope. It's this
it
tiny little thing.
Suck.
It's this little thing.
It looks like it holds.
Yeah, exactly. It looks like it holds a 26650, holds an 18650. It's got two adjustment buttons, one fire button. Mm-hmm. It does 70 watts. It does temp control for all the wires, all the normal wires. It's got custom TCRs. It looks a little bit like the old DNA screens. Like it shows resistance, voltage, wattage. Shows you what mode you're in. I've taken 121 P's. Puffs.
We love puff counters.
This, I learned without you, that this mod is designed to work with this honkin' wide atomizer called the Destroyer 2.
Yeah, well, you should save that for
I haven't built on this yet, so we're going to have to get to that in another vlog, but
it's
the same diameter. I got it topped with a black recoil. I got Alice on the inside. I vaped this all day today.
Yeah.
All day. I've been vaping it.
It's so cool.
It's super cool. Super good vape. Hi. Why did I do that? I pulled a RubyRoo. Oh, okay. It's firing.
I don't know why. I don't know. I think this was a thing that happened like a long time ago where I just had to like every time. Like if it's a mod that I don't know, like if it's someone else's mod or like a mod at a shop or something, you hold it up to your ear and make sure it's firing first.
Try that. Redrip it. And then I want to show them the coolest feature of that. That is the battery compartment. Why are you ripping the top off the recoil? You can blow through the middle. I made it specifically so you can blow through the middle.
I don't drip like that.
Ruby doesn't drip like a normal person. She drips like a crazy person, apparently.
Okay, frequent top cap taker offers. You're with me on this.
I remember you actually even talked about that in your first tugboat.
Yeah. Are you a frequent top cap taker offer like me?
Taker offer like me? Yeah. No, I am not.
Well, I am.
I insist on blowing my juice through the middle, and if I can't do that... The atomizer is just pure garbage.
Ugh, so much judgment.
I'm just saying. I'm just kidding. I would never do that. See? Why did you do it again? It reminds me... love this...
Damn, that Alice juice from Lanco Vapor is good. I'm sorry. I'll stop joking
about
that.
It's from January.
That's good. Alice steeps well.
I like these regulated tubes. I like this D30 guy, this big honker right here. Even though you can't adjust anything, I liked it. It's a tube.
I really like this guy.
So far. My first impression is, fuck yeah, V-Park. Really good job. What's the name of that thing? Look on the bottom. What's it called?
The...
It's called, like, the Annihilator.
No, the... The Quantum.
Quantum.
It's called the Quantum.
The V-Park Quantum. I'll put a link in the description. The only link I could find for the V-Park Quantum is an Alibaba link. This is literally all I could find. The stainless steel looks dope.
Ooh, the stainless. Ooh, stainless looks rad. Look at that, is that a white one?
Yeah,
it's white. I like white, the white one.
I like stainless.
I like the white one.
For some reason, the black one has red buttons. The stainless steel and white both have black buttons.
I kind of wish they would have kept the black buttons because I don't really super duper like but the red. Hard.
I would have liked white buttons on here.
Oh.
I would rock that hard. Cool. But so far, this has been great. Let me show you my favorite feature. The USB is not for charging. It said in the manual, don't charge it via the USB because it has a replaceable 18650.
Is that just for updates, firmware updates?
Yeah, apparently. So you unscrew the bottom, and then it's got this little flip tab. You see this little flip tab right here?
Let me
take the battery out.
That's the first thing I did to it.
Little flip tab on the bottom that pop. It just
shake it.
It's like a boxing.
A boxing bag.
Flip that top. You put your battery in positive side towards the atomizer. You flip the flip tab, and you screw the bottom back on. It's super easy.
So easy.
The threads are hard to find.
Apparently. Do you even vape, bro? Nope.
Why am I having such a hard time with this?
I don't know.
Okay, found the threads. Yeah, not bad. Not bad threads.
They're not crunchy.
It fires up. It asks you if this is a new atomizer, and you say, no, this is the same coil I've been using. And you just vape it. I've been using this all day. So far, I really love it. But like with all my first impressions, I need to spend way more time with it before I feel comfortable talking about it on video. I think I'm going to skip the Coilmaster thing.
Okay, let's skip
that. I'm going to do...
We'll do it next time. Do it later.
I'm going to do a video later for this Coilmaster thing. It's this. It's a thing that is used to build Claptons. And I haven't even tried it. So I don't want to spend too much time trying to figure out.
No, it would literally make a 3-hour long vlog.
So what we're going to do now, after all those first impressions, it's time for retro vaping.
Retro vaping. Oh, yeah. I'm so excited. This is my very first nice mod that I ever bought for myself when I started vaping in 2013. This is a TurtleShip mech mod.
Ooh.
TurtleShip. It's a TurtleShip.
Whistle tip.
Sorry. This is a TurtleShip. This is an atomic. This is an atomic RDA. And the very first drip tip, it is a Cherry Vapes Pawn Amber drip tip. I'm so excited.
I watched her rewicked it. I don't remember the deck on the Atomic being that small.
Dude.
It's got to be, what is that, like 15 millimeters?
It's got to be about a 15, 14.
It could be even smaller than that. It could be like a 10 millimeter.
I was like, I basically don't put any cotton in it.
Yeah, you cut the wicks right even with the coils. That's it.
That's all you have space for.
It's a high resistance build. Do you want to check the...
Oh, yeah, let's check the resistance.
You can use my Coilmaster Tab 251.
Oh, I'm going to have to adjust this for about 1,000 years.
Okay. Is the TurtleShip the one... Well, there was a mech mod, and I don't know if it was the TurtleShip, where people were putting a penny or a dime or something in it.
No, that's not this.
Okay.
This does have it's completely adjustable, but
here, check the resistance.
Sit here. Okay.
Unscrew this. How many vapors does it take? Oops. Nope. I did the top.
Oh, no! Don't do that!
I adjusted the airflow. Ruru is yelling at me. I'm just going to sit here and vape my V-Park while she gets madder and madder.
No, don't do that. Because the Atomic actually unscrewed completely apart, all of the drip-tippy jobbies.
Dude, did you see that O?
No.
That was the dopest O I've ever done. Fucking V-God status right there.
V-God. I can't unscrew it without unscrewing everything. Okay, we're just gonna...
That was the second dopest O I've ever done, and I'm glad my vloggers got to see that. My vloggers? Me. I'm the vlogger. Okay, we can't take this off of the mod, so...
No, I got it. I'm covered in e-liquid. Do you have a towel?
Look, there's a...
I need a towel.
Ooh, here. You guys,
this drawer is full of the coolest shit.
Look at this. Ew. This paper towel's been going for a month.
That's underwear.
It's just rags.
Just next to underwear.
It smells like a vape meat. It's all brown.
Yeah.
I don't like waste paper towel. Look how many different colors it is.
Ew. That's really gross.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay, we're good. And it's still recording?
I don't know.
Okay, it's still recording. Yeah, it's good. We're good. We're good. We're golden.
This is just covered in e-liquid.
Okay. Well, you're supposed to be checking the resistance.
No, you do that. You do that. You don't want to touch it, do you?
No, I want you to screw it. I'll screw it. Okay, go. I'm going to use the drip tip.
Oh.
So I'm going to check the resistance of this build. Is this the last build that you put in here?
Okay, so this build is actually the last build I put in here. This is a while ago.
0.94. 0.94.
Uh-huh. Do you even vape? Oh, can you vape it from there?
That felt like I was inhaling nothing, zero.
Nothing?
It just felt like I was inhaling non-existent.
This is how I vaped, apparently.
You've always liked cool vapes.
2.5 years ago?
You like cool vapes.
Not that cool.
That is ridiculous. 0.94?
0.94. It actually was registering on my thing at home, my little checker jobby.
Your ohm meter?
Yeah, my ohm meter.
Her thingy at home, the checker dealy jobber. So how long does it take you to adjust the turtle ship? Now, when you first reviewed the turtle ship, how did the review go? Was it good?
Oh,
was it bad?
I was like, I love it.
What I'm
going to
do is I'm going to track down this video. Yeah, RubyRoo is going to help me. I'm going to put it in the description so you can check it out.
You should find my atomic one, too.
I'll put my atomic one in there.
Well, but it's my retro vape.
Okay.
Ugh, he's so selfish.
Well, these things happen when you're in my office.
That's true. Yeah. Okay, so let's do that.
The vlog looks so much better now that the sun went down.
Is it? Yeah, we've been in here for a while.
Yeah, anyway.
It's not firing. Oh, there it goes.
Is. You can hear it. It's just the ramp up is unbelievable. This is a 0.94 mm-hmm. on a 3.7 volt, 18650, clouds bro clouds. I could probably do a whole other vlog while you're inhaling. Keep it going. Keep it going. Keep it going. Yeah.
We are vaping on Normal View from the GrimmGreen Signature line.
Oh, and that Normal View is so good.
I actually can't really taste it because this is such so a cool vape. Yeah, it's
so cool, and you can't. All the GrimmGreen Signature stuff is much better with some heat. I vape hot, so.
Oh, I got the cranberry.
Yeah. The cranberry is always first. Sugar cookie is super ex-Haley.
That's a really comfortable drip tip. Oh, yeah. I can actually adjust the battery.
Why does the battery rattle?
Oh, because it takes a half an hour to actually adjust it to get the battery to not rattle. I'm so excited. Yeah. Is it anything? Is anything happening? We don't know. Yeah. Keep it going. See? Sick clouds, bro.
Dope.
You just have to vape.
Dope.
Forever.
I want to enter a cloud comp with that.
Yeah.
And when the other guy's gone, he's already walked away and won. You're like.
Yeah, you're like still going. So, when we had this trip planned, Nick was like, "Oh, you know what? You should bring your retro vaping." And so I like immediately like looked through all of my stuff and I was like,
Turtle ship's happening.
Turtle ship. Brass contacts, bro.
What was the retail? Oh, yeah, brass contacts. See, mech mods, that's when we cared about things like, well, if the contacts aren't brass or copper or gold-plated rhodium.
This is pre-copper contacts.
But it had copper contacts, you just said. Brass contacts. Brass. Sorry, brass contacts.
This is pre-copper contacts.
What was the retail price of this?
I bought this for $140.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
People complained about the price of, tube mech mods. They were back in the day just known as mech mods. And they were like, people were like, oh, if it costs more than $1, I hate it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think that was actually a deal that my friend gave me.
So that was a discounted price.
Yeah. These were about $150 and $160.
Turtle ship clones.
Oh, yeah.
They have to.
They had
somewhere.
Like a million clones.
I want to try again. Let me try it again.
Well, I'm trying to get rid of the battery rattle.
Battery rattle so bad. It's okay. It'll vape with battery rattle.
It will.
That's
vape.
The thing.
That's the point.
How's the coils? Still super wet. Because...
No, I just re-dripped it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like still super wet because it's not using any of the juice. Because it's 0.94. This atomic, though, man. If you put
I mean, oh, we're gonna. I want to rebuild it immediately and
put something else in.
Because the Atomic was known for like flavor, and it also does have dual 3mm holes in it, so you can actually rip on it. But the deck is so tiny.
That's vaping, man. Here's the situation. Oh, here's hot. How I look at retro vapes.
That's hot.
If I got stuck with that, I could vape it.
Oh, yeah.
Sure, why not?
We'll just build it lower.
I'm not as spoiled as like, oh, the Pharaoh, you know, or oh, the recoil, or oh, the Sub-Zero.
Mm-hmm.
But that, I could vape that. Sure, why not? The juice actually kind of tastes pretty good in there.
It needs a rebuild, but holy crap, I really like vaping this again because it brings me back to 2.5 years ago when I vaped this setup.
Yeah, that was your setup, battery rattle and all. Cherry vape drip tip on top.
Oh, I love these cherry vape drip tip on top. Oh, fuck
yeah. So yeah, retro vaping. Thanks, Roo. Good time. Thanks for bringing the turtle shit back.
Heck
and
yeah,
brass 0.94.
Brass contacts 0.94.
So what we're going to do now is that was actually a pretty quick retro vaping.
It was a crick.
So what we're going to do is get to my favorite comments of the week. So I got a couple favorite comments of the week this week. In fact, our good advocacy friend Jennifer Coleman, she yes. sent me one of these comments.
Oh, sick.
Of the week.
She's busy.
Which is great. But a guy named Travis Rice,
mm-hmm.
and I just... This just meant a lot to me.
This is a good one.
He said, out of focus, Grim is better than in focus with someone else.
Aww.
Feels. There's feels.
That's lots of feels.
Thank you, Travis, for the very kind words. That just made my day. Mm-hmm. Second comment of the week is a awful comment.
Can I read it?
Sure.
Someone said, mega faggot.
What? Mega faggot.
Yeah.
Mega faggot.
So good.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Duh.
Mega faggot.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You're
whatever.
A bundle
I don't even
sticks.
Know what that is.
You're a huge bundle of
I am
sticks.
A mega bundle of sticks.
Mm-hmm.
Mega faggot. This is the one that Jennifer Coleman sent me, and she took a picture. There's no name. I don't know. Should I say the person's name or should I cut that out?
Okay, don't say I'll their crop name. It gives the trolls more power.
And then someone wrote... this was in last week's vlog.
Mm-hmm.
They wrote, I pleasured myself while watching you get a tattoo.
That's so awesome.
What the crap? Literally, what the crap is that?
That's good.
That is
so good.
That is gross.
That's so funny.
That's like what you say... That's like comments that you get.
Yeah, that's like the comments that I get for sure.
You're a dirty whore. I want to shit in your mouth.
Yeah, I had that once. I want to shit in your mouth.
Did you?
Yeah,
really?
Someone said that to me once. Ooh, okay. People say really gross things to me.
So this is one I found today.
Oh, this is my new favorite.
I'm going to cut this up into three different pictures.
Yeah.
So Alyssa left a comment and said, you sound like Seth Rogen, which I get a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I get a lot of that.
That
I get a lot of Seth Rogen. Yeah. And then what looks like a couple minutes later... She replied to her own comment and said, and look like Seth Rogen.
yeah. Mm-hmm.
I could see that. I get that a lot. Mm-hmm. And then she replied to herself again and said, are you Seth Rogen? Alyssa, that was amazing.
You sound like Seth Rogen. And look like Seth Rogen. Are you Seth Rogen? Like,
I have a feeling that you are Seth Rogen.
Yeah.
Another one, maybe it's this one that I sent to my... Yes. I just found this one today. We were working earlier.
We were working.
And I was going through comments and I found this brilliance. Well, part of what makes this funny is my reply as well. So a guy commented and said, cut your nails, Jesus. I replied and said, my name isn't Jesus.
but I think he might have thought that your name is Jesus.
Jesus?
Yeah.
Jesus Green?
Yeah, Jesus Green.
But a punctuation.
Yeah, a comma would have saved it.
Cut your nails, comma,
Jesus!
Exclamation point.
Yeah.
My name isn't Jesus. So there you go. That's, that's all my favorite comments of the week. We're going to wrap this vlog up because we've been in this hot office way too long. It's time to eat pizza, drink beer, and watch the Olympics.
Yeah!
Which I am pumped about, but Let me take a quick look around the room, see if I forgot anything.
Skip around the room.
I got stuff for next week. I got a whole bunch of tanks coming up. We're going to be, I'll talk about this in the next blog. I'm changing my format a little bit, but we'll get there when we get there. We're adapting to post-FDA regulations, post 8-8-16, post 8-8-16. So there'll be some changes coming up. No big deal. I hope you guys enjoy them. But I think I covered everything I want to cover.
Cultureofclouds.com.
Ruby and I have a podcast.
We do.
If you like what you saw in this vlog, you're more than welcome to join us every Sunday for the Culture of Clouds podcast.
Every Sunday night.
You can find it at cultureofclouds.com. You can find it on SoundCloud. You can find it on iTunes. Just search Culture of Clouds. That's our podcast. I love it.
Tons of office jokes. Star Wars jokes.
Tons of Star Wars stuff.
Yeah.
We talk about vaping, advocacy regulations.
We talk about beer, drinks, cocktails.
Big main topics every week that cover a lot of stuff. We've done non-vapey episodes.
Yeah.
We've done full vapey episodes.
We did an entire episode about Star Wars.
Yeah, we did an entire... We talked for almost 2 hours about
Star Wars.
It was fantastic. So, obviously, yeah, feel free to check that out. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching the vlog. I love it. I love the vlog. The vlog is my passion, and I really appreciate all the support and viewership, and it just means the world to me.
Thank you so much for having me on the vlog, dude.
Of course. You're not going to come to San Diego and not be on friggin' vlog.
I'm so excited. You guys, this has been so awesome.
Yeah, bro.
To see the vlog from the other side is like...
Because you watch the vlog, though.
Oh, yeah, every week.
And now you're on this side.
It's weird.
And so you get to see my cuts.
Yeah.
And like... The beer section.
The beer section is actually over there.
Technically, I do point at the beer section every time.
There.
Well, thank you,
Ruby,
of course, for coming on. If you like what you saw here, you can always find RubyRoo as well. She's on Instagram at RubyRooVapes, Twitter at RubyRooVapes, YouTube at RubyRooVapes.
Yeah, everything.
Great YouTube videos. I highly recommend checking them out. Give her a subscription. That would be fantastic. She's one of my nearest and dearest friends, and she does really great videos as well. So,
yeah, thanks, Dave.
Yeah, I think we're going to call this good.
Yeah, let's do it.
We'll see you guys next week for another vlog, and it will be a much more lonely vlog. I'm just going to cry for 2 hours. I'll be like, Mimi's gone. I don't even want to taste beer. And I'll knock shit over.
Just like throw it out the window.
Yeah. But yeah, that's what we got, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to grab my little V-Park here. We're going to enjoy some pizza, beer, and Olympics. That's what we got, everybody. Thanks so much for watching. And as always, yeah, let's keep on vaping.
Sick.
I was gonna vape capital.
Oh, I just said okay. Sick.
Sick.
It's okay. That was sick.
It's okay.
I'm sick.
It's on the video.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know.
It's not on the video.
Look at this. I feel like I'm putting my...
See, that's how I sync. Here's your thing.
My hair.
There's your sync. Okay. Here's your mod. Here's your Fudgy the Whale.
I need my Fudgy.
And don't try to...
I do understand audio recording.
Okay, I'm not saying that you don't. I'm just saying that you might not be aware of the severity of Fudgy the Whale's impact on the desk and the microphone.
That's why I'm probably going to put him down over
here. Well, you can put it on the vape mat because it's
vape mat.
Cushioned.
You know what I usually use?
What? A coaster?
It's a vape mat for that.
Okay. Sure.
I just like ruined your entire desk.
That's fine.
Start moving things.
Yeah, just make noise too. It's like... Yeah, do that.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, it's
great.
Good.
All right, we're ready to vlog now? Okay. Obviously, I'm going to introduce you first and be like, I have a very special guest on the vlog this week.
Sado.
RubyRoo Vapes.
You're going to say it like that? Yeah. Like you don't know who I am?
You guys. Okay, let me start.
Okay, silence.